Run inning in the seventh, 9-2 the win, couple of huge nights. Salvador Paniagua setting career highs in a Revs uniform with four hits and five ribbies. He went 4-for-4 and homered twice. Eric Patterson 4-for-4. Andres Perez hit a homer. Talvin Nash had a nice night. And the Revs now 28-23 in the second half. The problem last night, the Barnstormers haven't slowed down yet. They won both games in a doubleheader against Southern Maryland last night. So even though the Revs won, they actually lost half a game in the standings. They enter play tonight 4.5 back. Kind of a rotten deal there last night, but still certainly not out of it. And looking to take care of their own business and see what happens with 18 to go in the regular season, plus the suspended game in Southern Maryland. Camden 22-30 coming in tonight. And this evening we'll see right-hander Cody Scarpetta make his first home start with the Revs. And I think a big start for him, because after his Revs debut last week at Somerset, this will be the first time that he makes a start coming off a full five-day session with Fletch. And they had some very specific things to work on after that first start. So looking forward to seeing him make his home debut tonight. Overall in the league this season, 1-4 with a 4.47 ERA, but throughout much of the season, his numbers even better than that. Left-hander Bill Murphy will go for Camden. He is 5-14 with an ERA of 4.82. And once again, the Revs going for the series victory here tonight before welcoming in the Bridgeport Bluefish for four games on Labor Day weekend. We will take a timeout on our pregame. Ray will join me next. We'll take a quick look around the league and then check in with Mace as well. The Revs had a dress rehearsal tonight. They had their team photo taken in left field in the home whites. They have switched to gold for this game tonight as they get set out for pregame warm-ups on the field. And we'll continue to get you set for our game this evening coming up shortly. First pitch at 6:30 tonight, right here on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Want to learn to skate? Want to suit up and learn how to play some hockey? Come to the coolest place in town, York Ice Arena. Learn to skate programs are now available for all ages. For every skating ability, kids of all ages will learn how to feel comfortable on ice, how to stand, and perhaps most importantly, how to fall properly. Class levels range from beginner to freestyle, where you'll learn basic jumps, spins, and footwork. Classes are taught by York Ice Arena skating instructors from White Rose Figure Skating Club. No skates? No problem. Skate rental is included in your registration. Or get on the ice for our York Ice Arena hockey programs. York Ice Arena coaches will focus on teaching proper techniques needed for anyone interested in playing hockey. Rental equipment is available for beginning players, both boys and girls. So get on the ice. Learn to skate. Learn to play. Sign up now. Group skating lessons and beginners hockey programs are forming now. Plus, York City residents get a 50% discount. Register today. Go to YorkSkate.com and click on program info. York Ice Arena, the coolest place in town.
WellSpan has helped many professional, student, and recreational athletes stay at the top of their game. And they can do the same for you. Our winning team offers everything from concussion management and sports nutrition to physical therapy and more. For more information, call 877-482-5420 or visit wellspan.org/sportsmedicine.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Use your gold card every time you shop and you'll automatically receive your savings and rewards. And you'll get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Nell's, Sauble's, Wetzel's, Chris's New Oxford, and Stouffer's Downingtown Markets. So get into the game with some great savings at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Always a hit and always a great catch.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus 10 bucks in free food. So head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Back here at Santander Stadium, the Revs hosting the Camden Riversharks tonight. Daryl Henry alongside Ray Jensen. Ray, welcome in. And you have to decide on your Ritas for tonight.
I do. That's a tough decision.
Did you make your choice?
I think I did.
Okay.
Just got to tell what it is.
Okay. So I didn't want to interrupt you.
Oh, that's fine.
Get that in.
Georgia peach, please.
I went with mango. Thank you, Joyce.
Well, we got to make the fans aware.
Yeah.
Read and flavors available.
They need to know what we're up to here in the booth, and that is the most important thing in our lives currently is selecting our Rita's flavor
for
the night.
It is a hot night tonight, so we will need them.
It is indeed. And last night, Ray, great bounce back for the Revs, but at some point, hopefully, the Barnstormers will falter. That, unfortunately, did not happen last night. And, of course, Southern Maryland played a pretty sloppy game, gave up 5 runs in the middle innings in game 2 of that doubleheader and blew a 4-0 lead. So they kicked the ball around a little bit, and the Revs not getting a whole lot of help there, a team that Lancaster's playing 9 times down the stretch beginning with this series.
Yeah, well, I think at this point it's time for the Revs, not that they're necessarily doing this, but put Lancaster behind them this season, especially since there are no more meetings between those two teams in the regular season, and just focus on winning games, because before Lancaster can start losing games, the Revs need to win games consistently. So just focus on Camden tonight and then Bridgeport in the next couple of nights. And once the Revs get a rhythm of their own going, if luck falls on their side and the Barnstormers start slipping, the Revs will be right there to take advantage.
Yeah, well, and exciting times in the middle of this playoff push, and big win for them last night. Hopefully they can get a series win tonight. And looking ahead to tomorrow, by the way, on our station, you just came off the studio where we had game day with Game Time PA, and a nice couple of hours previewing the high school kickoff for tomorrow. And tomorrow night, our Wellspan Sports Medicine Game of the Week will be on WOYK1350.com, beginning at 6:30 Central at West York. We'll have the Revs game on radio, of course, and Central PA game day is Saturday morning at 9, and Ray, you get to sit in with Wayne for the first time, and I'm planning on being there as well. Let me tell you, sitting in with the coach, with Dr. Wayne, is going to be an experience for you Saturday morning.
I'm looking forward to it. I've had the good fortunes of hearing his PA voice when he hosts the Shipley Awards here at Santander Stadium. I like his stuff, and I'm looking forward to hearing him on Central PA game day in person. I've heard him on the radio before, last year when I, from time to time, helped out the station, but the BC there in person, that'll be interesting.
It's going to be fun. And actually, big weekend for football coverage. We've had all of these NFL preseason games on our station. Tonight we've got basically the first football game that really means a whole lot on our station this fall. After our game, we'll join number 2 ranked TCU at Minnesota in progress for our first college game of the year. Tomorrow night, Washington at Boise State. We'll join in progress, and Saturday morning at 11:30 a.m., pregame coverage begins for Stanford at Northwestern. So whether it's local or the national scene with the big college games on week 1 of NCAA football this weekend, we've got it for you right here. And a lot of exciting things coming up, including a big announcement next week that we will be unveiling shortly here on WOYK, so stay tuned for that. Meanwhile, we will take a break here on our pregame tonight. Mace will join us on the Broadway Transmission Manager's Report coming up next.
We're everywhere. Listen on the go with the WOYK mobile apps. Download today at WOYK1350.com.
Nobody can turn your backyard into a backyard paradise better than Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping. The outdoor pros at Paradise offer full outdoor maintenance, landscaping, hardscape design, and installation. And when it comes to fall planting, mulching, and cleaning up fallen leaves, you're in luck, Revs fans. Call before September 1st to schedule your fall cleanup and clean up with 10% off. Estimates are free. Fully insured. Call 577-6234 or check them out on Facebook. Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping in York.
Pain doesn't take Sunday off. Neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into WellSpan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
It's going to be another epic year in high school football, and Sports Radio 1350 is ready for kickoff. Tune in every Friday night this fall for the high school football game of the week,
presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine.
Plus, go to WOIK1350.com for a full breakdown of the teams and the players of the 2015 York Adams League. The high school football game of the week, presented by WellSpan Sports Medicine. Catch the action every Friday night on Sports Radio 1350,
online at WOIK1350.com,
or download the WOIK mobile app.
Hey, sports fans, great news. Now you can listen to Sports Radio 1350 anywhere with the new WOIK mobile apps. Stranded in Siberia? No problem. Kidnapped by wolves? It's not as bad as you may think. Wherever you are, WOIK is with you on the brand new mobile apps. York's only local sports station just went mobile and global. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK. First in York, first in sports.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Fans, it's time to go inside the clubhouse. For the latest on your York Revolution and tonight's matchup, it's the Broadway Transmission Manager's Report. Now, here's Atlantic League Manager of the Year, Mark Mason.
Well, Mace, big night for the offense last night, and early on, Jeff Singer, the first time seeing him, he kind of threw the invisible the first couple innings, but was it just a matter of your guys seeing kind of a funky lefty the first time and then making an adjustment or knowing what to look for?
Well, it might have been part of that, but it was also, I think, because he's a converted, you know, starter from being a reliever, and he hasn't had that many starts, I think. Once we got into the third and fourth inning, you started to see some of the velocity drop and some of the movement not quite be as sharp as it was. He was really good for the first, you know, three innings, and I thought he had some deception. The slider or changeup, whatever he was throwing that we were swinging at and couldn't touch in the first couple innings, was really a good pitch coming off his fastball because he was throwing 90-91. So he was, you know, he did a good job. I just think maybe it's one of those where maybe not quite built up enough, and he was out there. He battled. He had a high pitch count. I want to say maybe in the 80s or something like that. But actually, I think 98 pitches to be exact. I'm looking at it right there. he was out there for a while. I thought he did a good job, but I thought we made some adjustments, and we had some guys come up with some big hits.
Well, sticking with pitching, your guy last night, Gailey, was great again, and you know, finally a big offensive night for him. His previous four starts had all gone to extra innings, so no decisions for him. But seems like doesn't matter if it's a tie game or you have a big lead, he's going out there the same guy and giving it everything.
Yeah, I mean, I like what Frank's bringing to the table right now. He's doing a great job. He's competing. He's keeping us in the game. And at times, he's even really very dominant as well. So a lot of quick innings. A lot of 1-2-3 innings. So he has a plan. I hear him talking with the catchers when they come in, you know, after the inning's over. And so he's done a really great job for us. And it was a shame he couldn't finish it. I know he told me after the seventh inning he was going to finish it. And I told him, well, that would be up to him. He would have to be able to go easy, you know, nice and easy, 1-2-3. Not a lot of pitches, but unfortunately, we couldn't get there, and with the big lead, I have some guys that needed to throw anyway. I think Penny needed a map to get to the mound. he had been like a week since he had been out there. So, I told him even before the game, I said, we're probably going to have to draw you a map to get you from the bullpen to the pitching mound in the game. But so, I mean, it was important for Steven to get out there and throw, and obviously Eddie with the guys they had coming up in the ninth inning, I thought, was the right decision there. So, you know, we pitched well, and I'm sure Frank will get an opportunity to get a CG. I know Romby wants one too, so hopefully they'll be able to get that.
I guess for you, it's always a balancing act between using bullpen guys too much and not using them enough because they have to stay sharp too, right?
Yeah, it's hard. Like, I'm not trying to It's hard to manage a shutout. I mean, you're not going to manage a shutout. Your starting pitcher, if he goes out there and he gives up three runs in, you know, six or seven innings, that's a good job. And it, you know, when you're in a 1-0 game and your starter's out there, and you get into that fifth, sixth, seventh inning, and he finally gives up his, you know, first run or second run, it's not always a time to panic. You know, it depends on a lot of things that have happened up until that point. Like, did he dodge raindrops the whole time and, you know, and he was lucky to get there? Or was he pretty dominant during the first four or five innings to get to that point? So there's a lot of things that you look at. But, you know, I'm a believer, and I want the starting pitcher to give us as many innings as they can and keep us in the game. And then when I think it's time to turn it over to the bullpen guys, then we do that.
What were your thoughts on another big night for the offense and Paniagua in particular? He had the biggest game, but you had a few guys that had big nights, and the ball that Perez hit was something special to see, the way he went down and got that. But you had three guys in particular that really mashed it last night.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Paniagua and Patterson both had four hits apiece. Panny hit two home runs. Dre had a couple hits, had a home run. Nash had a couple hits, you know. So we had some guys that were swinging it pretty well last night, and they were able to pick up some of the other guys that, you know, were a little bit off last night. So it was good to see Sal break out. I mean, he's been working hard, and I think last night he kind of took a different approach than he's been taking, and, you know, he's in there again tonight, and, you know, we're not going to look for two home runs and four for four, but, you know, it would be just nice to see the same approach and be able to put the ball in play with some authority.
Well, tonight, Cody Scarpetta making his first home start. How much different do you think it is for him coming into this one, having had a full week to work with Fletch? And, you know, based on what we talked about last weekend, I guess he had a couple pretty specific things to work on coming off that last start.
Well, he did have a couple things, and he worked on them really well in between the starts, and hopefully he can take that into the game tonight. He had some really good bullpen sessions. I even had some of the catchers come in and tell me, you know, the couple adjustments that he made. The ball was really good, and the bullpens were really good. So, you know, now it's just a question of taking that into the game. That's what you do. You work on the side in between starts, and you try to take that into the game and not let the adrenaline and everything, you know, wear you out as far as your mechanics go, and not get too pumped up. Just try to stay within yourself and not think so much and go have fun with it.
All right, team photo coming up. You're going to smile nicely?
I don't know. I mean, I try to smile. There's so many people in there. People aren't looking for me anyway. So whether I smile or don't smile, I don't know that it really matters. But I'm sure you'll be in there.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
You know, we'll get you in there, and I'll be stuck in the middle between Fletch and Polo probably. So it'll be fun. And then we'll just have to figure out who the bat boys will be this year off the team with guys that sit in front with their legs crossed. So we'll figure that out when we get out there. It's usually a lot of fun to take the photos, and, you know, hopefully we won't be out there too long because it's a little hot today. But
that's right.
We're looking forward to taking the photo and looking forward to playing the game.
All right, Mace, thanks a lot. Good luck.
Thank you.
All right, Revs manager Mark Mason on the Broadway Transmission manager's report. Revs will be taking the field here shortly. In fact, I believe they are indeed queuing up the intro video here tonight. Well, the Revs 1-1 now in September, 1-1 on this homestand, which began a stretch in which they'll play 14 of the final 20 here at home this season, and looking for a series win to begin that stretch tonight. It's the final meeting of the season between the Revs and the River Sharks. York 10-6. Against Camden this year, 4-1 here at home. They had actually lost four straight before winning last night. Before that four-game skid, though, they had won seven in a row. It'll be Cody Scarpetta making his home debut. The numbers at Somerset on Friday night, 3 2/3, four hits, five runs, but four of those five runs in one inning, three on one swing. He had worked out of trouble nicely his first two innings. Lefty Bill Murphy for Camden, 5-14 with an ERA of 4.82 coming into play tonight. the league leader in losses this season with those 14 defeats. Revs taking the field for tonight's game. We'll take one final pregame break, and we'll have the starting lineups in first pitch. Game number 123 of the 2015 season coming up next.
You're running cross country. No one understands how they keep score. Your friends and family don't understand why you do it, but you understand how it makes you feel. So does Flying Feet.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sport Shoes has been supplying running shoes and apparel to Central PA's best since 1975. Their staff is made up of runners and coaches who understand your pleasures and your pains. If it's running or cross-country related, Flying Feet knows about it. And with the area's best selection of running shoes, running spikes, and running apparel, there's no good reason to shop anywhere else. Worried about prices? Didn't you hear? Flying Feet is a specialty athletic store without specialty store prices. Come see their selection of the best running shoes and spikes for men, women, and children. No matter what your size, your width, or your ability level, Flying Feet has a full line of running apparel and accessories. So run, don't walk, and talk running with a staff who knows.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, 1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, just off exit 18 of I-83.
High school football is back, and so is the High School Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Traditional rivals West York and Central meet Friday night. I'm Ron Ruman, Gareth Hissong, and I will have the action on GameTimePA.com. Jeremy Jones, West York's former offensive coordinator, returns after 2 years at the helm of York Suburban to fill the large shoes of his former head man, Ron Miller. Brad Livingston begins his 34th year as Panthers head coach. Central at West York Friday at 6:30 on the High School Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on GameTimePA.com.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
And the River Sharks tonight as Cody Scarpetta makes his home debut going through his warm-ups. The River Shark lineup tonight brought to you by Flying Feet. Michael Rocket at third base will lead things off. Patty Matera, the second baseman, is hitting second. Batting third is the shortstop, Brandon Chavez. In the cleanup spot, Carlos Guzman in right field. Joel Guzman was a late scratch from the lineup on Tuesday night, did not play last night either, but he is in there tonight. Guzman at base hitting fifth. Matt Gamble, their new addition who had been with Somerset, he will be DHing and batting sixth. Daniel Rocket will play center field. He hits seventh. Landis Wilson is the catcher hitting eighth, and Zach McPhee in left field bats ninth. Again, it's Rocket, Matera, Chavez, Guzman, Gamble, Rocket, Wilson, and McPhee. That lineup for the River Sharks brought to you by Flying Feet. And facing Scarpetta, who began the season with Bridgeport and really has tremendous stuff. Big breaking ball, fastball is plenty hard in terms of velo. And they thought that after that first start, seeing him for the first time, maybe just a little mechanical adjustment and kind of refining a couple of things between starts and an opportunity to work with Fletch for a full 5 days. He's ready to go here tonight.
Yeah, this is certainly going to be a different Cody Scarpetta than fans saw pitches last time out.
Michael Rocket leading off. Our Dasher Investment Services first pitch is over for a strike. Underway tonight. One of the things that I thought plagued Scarpetta was a lot of balls thrown and behind in the count as he misses high and away in that first start. In fact, his first batter had reached on a four-pitch walk, maybe a little amped up. The 1-1, and just missed away. Our plate ump tonight, Jim Clayton. First base is Nate Caldwell, Derek Mosha at third. And the 2-1. And a ground ball to third base, a jammed Rocket right to Pounds. He's got it, throws it across, and one away. One up, one down for Scarpetta to begin his Revs home career here tonight. Our stadium board, 95 degrees here at game time. hot and muggy here in early September. Revs in the gold tops, Camden in road gray. Here's Patty Matera. And Scarpetta missing high. Matera hitting at 249. He's into the two-hole tonight. They rest Eric Frain, who is on an eight-game hitting streak. There's a fastball just outside, 2-0. Didn't miss by much. Paniagua maybe a little motion over toward the Revs dugout, letting them know. The 2-0, and a swing and a fly ball, left center. Simmons and Patterson converge. It's Simmons, the birthday boy, in left center. Celebrating his 30th today, he makes the grab for out number two. A lot of birthdays on this team recently. Here's Brandon Chavez. Rami Lewis the other day. Or yesterday, to be specific. Here's Chavez, who's hitting at 264. Had his 17-game on-base streak ended last night. He takes a first-pitch strike. The Revs last night held him to 0-for-4 with three strikeouts and a groundout. The wind and the 0-1. And that misses high. Matt Neal celebrates a birthday on Saturday. So three this week. Pitch, and that's over for a strike. A changeup from Scarpetta. His breaking ball might be his best pitch. Big hook, but good solid fastball. He shows the changeup there too. There's the wind and the pitch, and a changeup down and away. Doubled up with it. 2-2. Chavez hitting at 264 coming in tonight. Wind, the 2-2, and he slaps it on the ground and through the hole, a base hit the other way. Well, it's either going to be at somebody or it's not, and this one was not. It was beaten into the ground, but right through between third and short. Now the inning continues for Carlos Guzman. And Guzman having a tremendous season and hot of late, hitting about 350 the last 10. He's tied for fifth in the league at 291 overall. First pitch from Scarpetta is down low. Guzman, 8 home runs. He's tied for third in the league in RBIs with 67. He's done plenty of damage against York, 367 against York. On the 1-0, and he swings, fouls it back, out of play. He's had some very clutch hits for his team against the Revs as well. Briefly with York back in 2011. He had a clutch hit or two for them too, and a walk-off hit against Lancaster. Here's a ground ball pulled toward first, just foul. Nash reaching. It'll skip down to the York bullpen. And the Revs facing the lefty Murphy tonight. Mace has both Nash and Perez in there. Dre is DHing tonight. Scarpetta looking for a scoreless first. He's set. The 1-2, and a liner left center, and it'll be down for a hit, and Patterson can't cut it off. It'll bounce to the fence. Chavez being sent. Valdez the relay home, and it's taken just in front of the plate. Carlos Guzman does it to the Revs again, an RBI double the other way, and Camden with a first inning run. It's a 1-0 lead. Had the first two outs, but Chavez... a ground ball through the hole, and then Guzman got one up to the gap and opens the scoring tonight. We'll bring up Joel Guzman, who is in the lineup for the first time in this series. Scarpetta trying to end the string at Just two straight two-out hits. First pitch to Joel Guzman is upstairs. And he is, well, was tied with Carlos Guzman for third in the league in ribbies. 67. Carlos just picked up his 68th. They are not related. Here's the 1-0. And he swings and fouls it back. Out of play. Joel from the Dominican Republic originally. Carlos is from Brooklyn, New York. Joel had some big league time with the Dodgers several years back. Big presence in the box. Scarpetta holds, delivers, and a foul back and out of play. Joel listed at 6'7", 225 pounds. Scarpetta, no slouch, 6'3", 250. Fires home, and a curveball. Guzman just got a piece. There's that big hook. And Guzman just nicked it to hang in there. It's sharp. It comes in at 71 on our board, but it's sharp. Nods, yes. Another 1-2, and a swing and a pop foul, back out of play. Got in on him with a fastball at 91, following that curve, but Guzman able to foul it off. He's batting 267, 11 home runs. Scarpetta into his stretch. And the pitch, it is swung on and missed. Fastball got him at 90 on the outside corner, and that'll end the inning. Camden does break through, though, with a two-out rally for the game's first run. Couple of hits, one man left. And at the end of a half, it's the Sharks 1, the Revs coming up.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles. Whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both, it is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com. Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus 10 bucks in free food, so head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
An invasive pest that's already killed millions of ash trees is bearing down on our communities. The emerald ash borer, or EAB, means certain death for every ash tree it infects. The good news is that you can protect your property's ash trees with help from Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care. Our EAB prevention methods are effective, environmentally safe, and less costly than removing your dead tree, which is the only alternative to prevention. Learn more at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Camden, the early run, 1-0. Revs come to bat. Mikey Reynolds leading off. Bill Murphy's first pitch of the night is a little bit high. Set the Revs lineup for you here momentarily. As Mikey gets us started, Murphy just 5-14, but he has had a couple of gems. Deals home, misses high and away. Mikey in there at 296. He has been held without a hit for a season-high four straight games. 2-0. That's over for a strike. Before the last four, he'd been going along pretty well, had hit safely in six in a row, drove in a run in five in a row. Here's the 2-1. Swings and fouls it to the right of the net, and it bangs upstairs. 2-2 to start him off. Murphy at 4.82 ERA. It's his fourth start against York, 1-2 against the Revs. A long look over his glove, and Mikey will ask for time and back out. 1-2 in three starts against York with a 5.21 ERA. He deals, and it's in the dirt. His catcher tonight, Landis Wilson, dropping down on top of it. Oh, full count. Murphy the wind and the pitch. And a swing and a chop foul. That ball, a changeup that was fading down. And Mikey went down, maybe out of the zone to get a piece. And it bounced right by the plate, high up in the air, and foul over toward Camden's dugout. On the wind, Murphy will try it again. And he missed down low. Leadoff walk for Reynolds to begin things. Here is the York lineup brought to you by Flying Feet. It's Reynolds at second. Wilson Valdez, the shortstop. Eric Patterson in left field. Cleanup man, Brandon Boggs in right. Then Andres Perez will DH and hit fifth. Brian Pounds at third base is batting sixth. Bottom three, Talvin Nash at first. Salvador Paniagua catching and James Simmons in center. So again, Reynolds, Valdez, Patterson, Boggs, Perez, Pounds, Nash, Paniagua, and Simmons for the Revs. And here's Valdez, who shows bunt and leaves it high and away. Ball one. Valdez hitting 264 coming in tonight. Revs down 1-0 in the first. Leadoff man on, though, and he shows bunt again and does push it to first. Guzman looked at second, throw to first, and he's called out. And I don't know about that. From up here, it can be deceiving, but it certainly looked like he was through the bag. Again, from all the way up here, it's tough to know sometimes, but I wasn't the only one up here that looked up in shock when they called him out at first. That is a sack bunt for Valdez, his Revs record 41st. All time, and it sets a new team record, breaking his own record from a year ago with his 21st this season. 3-4 on the out. Here's Eric Patterson, who takes a strike. Patterson batting at 250 after a 4-for-4 night last night. Mikey getting a little more on that lead. Pitch is fouled back into the net. Getting a little bit more from second in the event of a base hit. Give himself the best chance to score on it. Patterson, over his last eight games now, hitting 317. There's the 0-2. And it's up and away. Good eye. Started to step toward it, but let it go. Last night, his second four-hit game of the year. Murphy steps off. Revs with Patterson and Paniagua with four-hit games last night. And they've now had 18 players this season total four hits in a game. Pitch. Oh, hit him. Way up and in. And a late duck. And it still got him. Looked like back of the front arm, the right arm. And he will head to first base. A hit by pitch, and it's first and second for Brandon Boggs. Revs with the table set, looking for their first hit. As Boggs digs in, and Murphy delivers, and it's over for a strike. Boggs has hit 322 against lefties. One of the Revs' best overall at 263. He'll bat from the right. Quick delivery from Murphy, and Boggs pops it up. Shallow right. Carlos Guzman hustling in. He'll call off his second baseman, Matera, and make the grab. And that's out number two. I don't know if Boggs was at all surprised by how quickly Murphy delivered. He barely came set. Out number two, and Andres Perez to the plate, trying to make something of this first inning threat. Gray drove in two last night, including his 13th home run, which puts him in the top five in the league, and he's by himself leading the league again in ribbies with 71 as Murphy lifts and looks Mikey back. Gray now has hit four of his 13 homers against Camden, including that walk-off in July that went into orbit as he takes down low. One ball, no strikes. He is seventh in the league in total batting at 290. He's also now fifth in runs scored. Pitch to him, and it's a called strike over the outer half. Against the Sharks, he's hit 364 this season. Revs trying to answer Camden's first inning run. Murphy holds, stares back, pickoff play on, and they got him. The second baseman, Matera, snuck in, and the tag on Mikey's forearm just before he could get the fingers back on the base. He's upset with himself, and normally the second baseman is the runner's responsibility, and I think Matera broke right when he was looking over to his right, and he didn't see him right away. No runs, no hits, two men left, or actually one man left. We go to the second, it's still 1-0 Camden.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our Atra certified technicians.
Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. Still, with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA-approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
WellSpan has helped many professional, student, and recreational athletes stay at the top of their game. And they can do the same for you. Our winning team offers everything from concussion management and sports nutrition to physical therapy and more. For more information, call 877-482-5420 or visit wellspan.org/sportsmedicine.
For local sports on your smartphone, search WOIK at the App Store.
One-nothing Camden as we head to the second. And Matt Gamble will lead things off. New team for him as of yesterday. He'd been with Somerset, but every time we saw him, he was on their bench. First pitch of the inning from Scarpetta is up high. Gamble did not put up the numbers that he expected to in Somerset. Pitch to him is down and in. But he did have a big home run here back in late May, and he was so excited that ended up eventually leading to a bench clear. Here's a line drive at third, and it's caught by Pounds, an inside-out swing. And kind of a soft liner low to the ground. Pounds caught it just above the dirt. Showed it to the third base ump, Derek Moshe. Now one away. Campbell had said afterward that he wasn't trying to rub it in. He just was so excited after a comeback that had seen him suffer two ACL injuries over the years. As Daniel Rocket takes up high. But early in the season, the Revs took exception to it, and they had their first of a couple midfield get-togethers with Somerset as Scarpetta fires a strike on Rocket. Rocket, a home run last night, is 14th of the year. Ranks fourth in the league. On the 1-1 curveball, and that clipped him. That big hook from Scarpetta, but it started too far in and got a piece of him. A hit by pitch and a one-out base runner. On our Wellspan Sports Medicine Injury Report, Revs with Brad Bergeson and Ian Durham sideline with the elbow injuries. Anthony LaRue, the broken leg. It's your Wellspan Sports Medicine Injury Report. Here's Landis Wilson, the Camden catcher. He's 1-for-4 at the plate. First pitch, a fastball right there for ball one. Here's the stretch. Now the 1-0. And that misses down low. I bit my tongue that time, Ray.
He did. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
Baby steps.
Just wanted to point that out.
You don't need a third bloopers promo this fast.
It's the 2-0. And that's down and away. Oh, he's the K-man tonight. Wilson, who debuted the other night. There's the stretch from Scarpetta. And the 3-0. That just missed a little high. Well, the first one should have been a strike, but see, there I did it. I went and did it. And it's a walk. First and second with one out. Couldn't do it any longer. Here's Zach McPhee. He's hitting at 194, but had a 3-for-3 night here in the opening game that they won. And the first pitch, it is right in there, a called strike. McPhee on Tuesday night, a pair of RBI singles, also tripled. Now the 0-1, and a swing and a lazy fly ball to shallow left. Patterson charging in. He's got it. Running in toward the infield, two down. And we'll pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Revolution Radio.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
A 2-on, 2-out, top of the order, Michael Rocket. Scarpetta delivers, and a swing and a foul over the first base side. It's 1-0 Camden here in the top of the second. 2-out rally that included a single and a double for their first inning run. And Scarpetta trying to slam the door on this inning as he steps off. And Now into his stretch. And the 0-1, runner's fake going, and Rocket fouls it. Back into the net, his younger brother Daniel is the lead runner at second base. Both boys from Sugar Land, Texas. That's where Michael had played his first two Atlantic League seasons. Daniel joined Camden in May this year after beginning the year in the Royals system. Here's the pitch. And in the dirt and ricochets behind Paniagua, who couldn't find it at first. He'll slide to the backstop as Daniel Rocket had gotten to third and took a big turn. Paniagua frustrated, he slams the ball down as they give Scarpetta a new one. It's a wild pitch, and Camden now has second and third. It was 0-2, now 1-2. Well, now a base hit could be even more damaging. Scarpetta trying to get the hitter here and not worry about it. A lengthy look in, and now as he nods yes, time of course will be asked for. Rocket a ground out to third base, his first at bat. Trying to keep it a one-run game, the stretch, and the 1-2. Curveball, and he slaps it on the ground. Great backhand pick. Talvin Nash, he spins, slides for the bag, and just got him. Saving a run on a tremendous play at first base. Rocket tried to punch it into right. Nash made the backhand grab. He spun and won the race against one of Camden's fastest. He got there with a feet-first slide into the bag. No runs, no hits. Both runners left in scoring position. We go to the bottom of the second, still 1-0 Camden.
Maple Donuts knows that there comes a point in every kid's summer when the feeling of unfettered freedom begins to fold up faster than a picnic blanket at the first drop of an unexpected summer storm. Charlie and his Maple Donuts team understand that all too soon, lazy mornings on the sofa, splashing in the pool, and weeknight sleepovers will be replaced by bus stops, backpacks, and morning announcements. But Maple Donuts says there's a bright side to the first day of school, kids. Because when you stumble into the kitchen that first morning, chances are you'll be greeted by Mom, enjoying her cup of Maple Donuts' famous coffee and sitting next to a back-to-school tradition, a box of Maple Donuts. And somewhere buried in that box, handpicked by Mom from Maple Donuts' 58 varieties, you may find that, yes, summer is over, but another school year may not be so bad after all. So for every kid coming to grips with going back to school, we say thanks, Mom. And thank you, Maple Donuts.
Maple Donuts taste right.
Joel's Painting and Contracting is a proud sponsor of the York Revolution. They are also a partner in the maintenance of Santander Stadium. Joel's Painting and Contracting is the highest rated painting company in York and Lancaster County. Now is the time to call for great deals on all of your interior and exterior projects. A community partner with thousands of happy clients, hit a home run of Joel's Painting and schedule an appointment today or give them a call at 717-471-4273. That's 717-471-4273 for Joel's Painting and Contracting.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Still 1-0 Camden. We begin the bottom of the second, and Bill Murphy can't get together with Landis Wilson on the first pitch of the inning. And Perez will back out. He was at bat when the pickoff occurred to end the first. First pitch here is jacked! Watch this one go! Way out of here! Over the arch nemesis in left. A no-doubter for Dre. 14th of the year and his league-leading 72nd run driven in. Ties the game at 1-1. Out toward the trees on the other side of Arch Street. Well, I guess that step off trying to get together on the first pitch maybe was not the one they wanted. And he absolutely clobbered it. Unfortunately, it didn't come with two men on like when he was at bat last inning, but he does tie it up. Here's Brian Pounds, who looks at one down and away. What an eye-opening shot that was. No doubter, a sweet swing, and that thing took off right off the barrel of the bat. No question. And now Murphy steps off again. This is supposed to be when the pitcher is in his rhythm with nobody on base. Here's Pounds, who grounds it to third. Michael Rocket with it. And a throw across to first for out number one. There is a strange pace, or lack thereof, to the start of this game tonight. It's kind of a strange feel for some reason. I don't know what it is. Here's Talvin Nash. Maybe it's me, Ray. Maybe it's me.
It might be you. It might be.
Here's the first pitch to Nash, and he chops a foul, third base side.
It's 93 degrees, maybe starting to become delirious due to heat.
Well, like an old dog, I am getting older. Pitch to Nash is up high. Dogs don't like the heat. And I generally could take it or leave it. There's a pitch down in the dirt, 2-1. I'll deal with it. Murphy delivers, and that's over the outer half for a strike. We didn't even have time to name our Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care home run participant yet tonight, as Nash looks at one in the dirt. But we're going to now. Ashley Saltmarsh, congratulations, Ashley. You win a prize pack courtesy of the Revs and Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, thanks to Dre's Blast. Here's a swing and a line drive, base hit right center. And Nash with another sharp knock. He'll take his turn, stops with a single. Pair of hits last night. So Ashley, you can stop by the Apple Chevrolet ticket office during normal business hours anytime at your convenience. And that prize pack is yours. Here's Paniagua, who teed off last night.
Over the wall!
Yep, he did that last night.
Twice.
First pitch is down and away, a changeup. Maybe she was here to see that. Had two bombs last night. Five RBIs, 4-for-4. 1-0, and a swing and a pop-up foul out of play, off to the right. The hit total and RBI total for him last night, the highest of his Revs career. 1-1, and a swing and a foul tip squeezed. The multi-home run game, the seventh of his career. Second with York. Last one was May 29th of 2011 in Bridgeport when he was less than a month into his Revs career at the time. Murphy settles the 1-2. Breaking ball, swing and a miss. That thing started middle in. Paniagua, I don't think, recognized that it was a curve, and he committed and couldn't stop. Broke way in on him. First strikeout of the night for Murphy. And here's the birthday boy celebrating his 30th, James Simmons to the plate. With Nash at first and two outs. Simmons hitting at 218. Combined between York and Bridgeport. First pitch is up a little bit. It's one homer, 34 knocked in. Native of Irving, Texas. Pitch is swung on and missed. One ball, one strike. A sack fly last night, also walked and stole a base. 11th RBI in his last 13 games. pitch. That's high and away. Two balls and a strike. Revs have tied it 1-1 here in the second on Perez home run. Pitch to Simmons is a high strike called, and it's 2-2. Dre's home run on the first pitch of the inning. Well, Murphy delivers, and it's high and away. Simmons checking indeed as they appeal down to first base. A full count, and it'll give Nash the head start from first. And he goes. Pitch is tipped foul right at the feet of the catcher, Wilson. That will do it again. There's Everett. Not tending to the visiting team. He's out here watching. Oh, a pick move to first and the throw down to second. And safe is the call as Nash slides around it. And here comes Chris Widger running out. Joel Guzman had played behind Nash with a 3-2 count with two outs. Nash had his big lead. Guzman snuck over, and it was a pick move kind of leading him toward the bag. He wasn't there initially, but kind of like leading a receiver. And Nash, rather than trying to get back, broke for second. And Chavez receiving the throw from Guzman, but took it to one side of the bag. Nash went to the backside, and Derek Moshe said he got in. Now it'll go as a stolen base for him. And a runner in scoring position. And I believe they got the call right. His foot was in on our blurred replay.
Looks like that famous Bigfoot footage where it's just a big blur. You don't know whether it's Bigfoot or not. The Patterson film, I believe it's called.
There's a curveball grounded foul, third base side.
But that evidence is real life. More real than Bigfoot, though. So it does its job.
Now, is that named after the guy who shot it?
Yeah. It was a gigantic hoax.
Oh.
From what I'm told. Just a man in a monkey suit. Like, probably more than half of those sightings. Not the case in that replay, though. No. Bigfoot was not involved.
No, this was very real.
It's a crucial play, too.
Another 3-2. Swing and a miss. And Murphy gets him on a curveball down and in, tag applied, so it will not come back to bite the Sharks, but the Revs do tie it on Perez tape measure home run. Two hits, one man left, and we head to the third. It's a 1-1 game.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax-sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats, a savings of 25% over box office prices, plus $10 in free food, so head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
York Sports on your mobile device or online at WOYK1350.com.
Hi, this is Logan Williamson. You're listening to York Revolution Baseball on the home of the Revs, Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
One our score as we start the third. Cody Scarpetta to face Patty Matera. He fires a strike. Camden a first inning run on a little two out piece together. Revs answering Andre's blast. Here's a number foul over toward the York dugout. Matera so early on that changeup that he ends up cueing it off the end of the bat. He flew out his first time up. 2-3-4 in the order due. And Scarpetta fires home and misses high and away. He had first come to the league with Lancaster last season. And then with Bridgeport earlier this year. A 1-2 curveball in the dirt. As Paniagua smothers that. Tell you one thing, he was here for about a day, maybe 2 days. And we had ourselves another fantasy football player signed up. The wind, the 2-2, and a ground ball toward the middle. It will get through. A base hit for Matera to lead off the third. It's crawled up the middle. He had been just 3-for-21 his previous six games. That didn't take long for Scarpetta to get in, and Ray will be joining us as well and find out our draft order tomorrow night. So I probably won't be able to sleep tonight. It's Brandon Chavez. He singled to left in the first, and he bunts and drags it down to first, and they're going to let it go. Wise play by Nash, who eventually has to pick it up and applies the tag. Sacrifice is good, and that was smart by Nash because Chavez had kind of stopped running, so he had time to let it roll and see whether it would go foul or not, and he waited as long as he could without having to rush the play, determined that he had to pick it up, and does apply the tag. Sacrifice is good. Thing rolled most of the way down to first base. Now runner at second, one out for Carlos Guzman. And the first pitch, he swings and misses. They start him with a changeup, and he was swinging fastball and didn't get it. He doubled to left center in the first, driving in their run. Now the stretch. And the 0-1. Fastball missed high. Scarpetta with Bridgeport, a 3.76 ERA, but through July 23rd, the ERA was about 1.5 through six games, three starts. Here's the 1-1. That's down low. Through August 9th, it was just 2.23. His last two startings, he was roughed up a little bit, but he was, excuse you, Everett. This is the 2-1, and that misses low. But Scarpetta at times was extremely good. He had a start against Sugarland where he gave up just one hit in four innings. His next start, five no-hit innings at Southern Maryland. That was in July. Here's a swing and a miss on a changeup. And the count now full. And Guzman, I think, just motioned to the plate that he needs a moment. That one hurt his left wrist, which is a top hand for the left-hand hitter. He's shaking it off as he takes a walk around behind the plate. Now back in. Count is full. Revs are going to get Bo Vaughn up in the bullpen. Pitch is swung on, tapped softly. Scarpetta over toward first. He'll pick it up and underhand it off. And that's out number two as Matera goes to third. Scarpetta at 50 pitches now. And he hasn't gone overly deep into games this season. In fact, in the first half, he missed about 2 months with a hamstring injury. At one time, he had ascended to second on the Brewers prospect list. That was in 2011. But unfortunately, the next year, he had Tommy John surgery. Here's Joel Guzman. Swings first pitch, pops it toward the Revs bullpen. Nash a look, and out of room. It lands up at the top of section one. Guzman a strikeout in the first. Scarpetta was an 11th round pick of the Brewers out of high school in 07. Made it to AA, made it almost to the top of their prospect list, according to Baseball America, but then unfortunately the injury. Now ready, and the 0-1. Swung on, grounded to deep short, and Valdez will get in front of it. He'll have time as he snaps it across, and the inning's over. Leadoff single and sack bunt, and Matera makes it to third, but he's left on there. Valdez able to get in front of that ball to his right. And a long throw, plenty of time to get Guzman. We'll go to the bottom of the third, tied at one.
Whether it's for sport, protection, or recreation, Spar Firearms is the best place to go for all of your firearm needs. With a large selection of new and used firearms, Spar carries an array of brands, as well as ammo and other accessories. Whether you're an avid collector, sharpshooting expert, hunter, or weekend enthusiast, Spar Firearms provides everything you need, no matter your experience. For the best in convenience, selection, and customer service, visit Spar Firearms, 6108 Carlisle Pike in Mechanicsburg, and online at sparfirearms.com.
Turn this on.
The Rich Eisen Show.
He is unbelievable.
Rich Eisen.
Let's go to the phone lines. They are lit. Catherine in South Carolina, can I help you?
Yes, I am having emotional distress.
Don't.
I'm going to sue the Jones family.
Don't.
This is crazy. It's the most stupid, idiotic thing. The Jones are screwing this up. And I am sick. I've left work. I'm nauseous. He's strung us out. Come to Marco.
Well, what about the idea that anybody could run behind that offensive line? Catherine, you don't buy that one?
DeMarco is family. He and Tony and Jason do everything together. He's family. I just started to be a Cowboys fan again, and happiness has just plunged to despair. What the Jones has done to my emotional state, they should be sued.
Don't go litigious on me here, okay?
This is the Rich Eisen Show.
Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports. First in York, first in sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the third as Mikey Reynolds fouls the first pitch off. 1-1 our score, top of the order for the Revs. As Murphy, the lefty, looks in, he winds and delivers. And a swing and a pop-up foul. Joel Guzman at first will give it a look. And at the stands, it lands about six rows up. No balls, two strikes. I mean, Mikey, Valdez, and Patterson here. On the wind, the 0-2. And a curveball looped the other way, foul. Into section one again. One of those gems for Murphy came in his most recent start, 7 scoreless in a win against Sugarland his last time out. He deals, and a foul the other way, first base side. Last month, the game against Lancaster, he had a complete game shutout. 34 years old and has big league time with Toronto and Arizona. Another 0-2, and it's up high. It was with Long Island back in 2013. Now deals, and a backdoor curve missed away, 2-2. Last year he played in Taiwan. He's also pitched in Japan. On the wind up and the 2-2. Swing and a miss. A changeup down. And he gets Mikey swinging. He has struck out his last 3 hitters. There's one away. Our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard. Barnstormers hosting Southern Maryland tonight. Both teams have scored. It's 1-1 in the bottom of the second. Somerset at Sugarland will start in about half an hour. Bridgeport a 2-0 lead at Long Island in the fourth. Here's Wilson Valdez. He looks at a strike over the outer half. And set a team record in the first inning. He broke his own record from a year ago for sack bunts in a season, his 21st this year. 41st all time with York, adding to the career record as he takes strike two. Takes a little time outside of the box. And ready. Here's the 0-2. And a curveball. He just got a piece of it. Murphy, a third-round pick of the A's in 0-2. Out of Cal State Northridge. He was sent to the Marlins in one trade, then to the Dodgers in another. He deals, and it's high and away. Count 1-2. The wind and the pitch. And a foul upstairs. First base, sweet level. After the 0-3 season, traded to the Marlins, completing a trade for Mark Redman. Another pitch to Valdez, and it breaks into the dirt. He lays off, the appeal confirming that. Deadline in 0-4, the Marlins traded him to the Dodgers, and then a day later, the Dodgers shipped him to the Diamondbacks. He never did suit up in LA's system. And it was with Arizona that he would eventually make the majors. It's called up for the first time for 10 games in 0-7. 2-2, swing and a miss. As a changeup kept down again, and he struck out 4 in a row. 2 down here in the bottom of the third. And Eric Patterson coming up. He was hit by a pitch in the first. Murphy also 8 games with Toronto in 0-9. First offering here is swung on and missed. He also had 14 losses with Long Island 2 years ago, 4-14, 5.50 ERA. The 0-1, and that misses up high. He's had a tough couple of Atlantic League seasons. The 1-1. And a swing and a pop-up foul. This will come back on the third base side. 1-2. We are tied at one here in the bottom of the third inning tonight. Murphy the pitch. Curveball, swing and a miss. A foul tip squeezed. He strikes out the side. Five hitters in a row, in fact. And that'll end the inning. We head to the fourth. Ray will have the play-by-play. Revs and River Sharks tied at one.
Payne doesn't take Sunday off. Neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into Wellspan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
It's going to be another epic year in high school football, and Sports Radio 1350 is ready for kickoff. Tune in every Friday night this fall for the high school football game of the week,
presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine.
Plus, go to WOIK1350.com for a full breakdown of the teams and the players of the 2015 York Adams League. The high school football game of the week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Catch the action every Friday night on Sports Radio 1350,
online at WOIK1350.com,
or download the WOIK mobile app.
Waking up with the Zabe.
The Steve Zabin Show.
And I know people, I can already hear you screaming at your radio. You don't even have a real job, Zabin. You just sit in front of the microphone and flap your cake hole around. I understand that. I'm not upset to be back today. I need to get back. I need to get back on the horse and get back riding again. I'm just saying it's going to take me a segment or two to get up to speed.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
Well, I present coming out to Lincoln Park. Thanks, Daniel. But regardless, top of the fourth here at Santander Stadium. It's a 1-1 tie between the Revolution and the River Sharks. Bill Murphy, the starter for Camden tonight, has struck out five in a row. He struck out the side in the third and ended the second with two consecutive strikeouts. He, after some early struggles in the second, couldn't get on page with his catcher, Landis Wilson, gave up a solo home run to Andres Perez, has settled in thus far. Gamble settles in, and Scarpetta's first pitch to Gamble. Nice running grab by Telvin Nash. The relay behind Scarpetta. Gamble reaches first, and they're going to award him second on the errant throw. Error will go on Nash. It's Gamble at second down to lead off the inning. Daniel Rocket starting at center field tonight. His second time up. Was walked his first time in the second. Paniagua settles in after he puts on the mask once again. Threw it down to try to help out when need be on that last play. Rocket settled. Scarpetta's first throw is a little high for ball one. 1-0 the count on Rocket. Another quick look back at second where Gamble's waiting, and the 1-0 from Scarpetta finds the chute for strike number one. One ball, one strike now on Daniel Rocket. Was drafted by the Kansas City Royals in the ninth round. 2013 Major League June Amateur Draft. University of Texas at San Antonio. 1-1. Down and away for ball two. Two balls, one strike on Daniel Rocket. Daniel Rocket spent last season with Wilmington. Hit .205. Three homers and 28 driven in. 2-1 from Scarpetta, swung on by Rocket, tracking towards center field. Simmons has a read on it and puts it away just a tad before the warning track for a throw to third. not get Gamble. He is there standing, but one away now with Rocket out on that fly out to center field. Gamble now at third with an out. Time for the Little Caesars K-man of the game, his second at bat, Landis Wilson, the catcher. He was walked his first time up. We have Adam McAllister in the PA tonight, and he has not hesitated to pepper the K-man with early breadsticks chance. Scarpetta looks over it. First get on track there, and now looks in. Scarpetta readies. The first offering to Wilson, swung on and missed. Got nothing but air on that hack. 0-1 on Wilson now. Breadsticks chance now raining down. And the 0-1 from Scarpetta. Another swing and a miss by Wilson. Make it 0-2 on him now. Will we have breadsticks in the fourth? Breadsticks chance louder now. With an 0-2 count for Wilson. Steps out for a brief moment now. Settled it again. Scarpetta is ready in the 0-2. Another swing and a miss. Three pitch strikeout, and we have breadsticks here tonight at Santander Stadium. The second strikeout for Scarpetta this evening. Both of them with swinging. Now two away with Gamble at third. Zach McPhee now up for his second at bat. Still a 1-1 game between the Revs and the River Sharks, top of the fourth. McPhee, his last time up, flew out to left. He exploded on Tuesday. The opening game of this series, going 3-for-3, driving in two of RBI singles in his first two at bats. Scarpetta starts him off. Pitch right over the plate, but McPhee gets the tip of it with his bat. Fouls it off to the third base side. 0-1 on McPhee. Scarpetta settles in the 0-1. Tad high for ball one. One ball, one strike on McPhee. Scarpetta settles in the 1-1. Cannot get the outside corner. Now 2-1 on McPhee. McPhee, just like Daniel Rocket, was drafted in the amateur draft. And will be held in June. He was part of the amateur draft in 2008 of June. Drafted out of O'Connor High School in Phoenix, Arizona. Did not sign. Also, McPhee, a former Pac-10 Player of the Year at Arizona State in 2010. He takes a swing and a miss and a 2-1 pitch from Scarpetta. 2-2 now on McPhee. He'll step out and take a little trek around the dirt. Not happy of himself on that one. He steps back in and readies for the 2-2 from Scarpetta. The 2-2 from Scarpetta. A little check up near the chin by McPhee, and that'll foul off towards third base side, but short foul just off the net. Still 2-2 on McPhee. River Sharks trying to break the 1-1 deadlock. And we're running at third and Matt Gamble. Gamble had a single, but then was rewarded second on an error at first. And reached third off a flyout from Daniel Rocket. 2-2 from Scarpetta. Swung on by McPhee, fielded by Pounds at third. Comes forward and the throw over to Nash at first is in time. And that'll be the end of the inning. The Revs keep it a scoreless inning, and it remains a 1-1 tie as we head to the bottom of the fourth here.
Tennis used to be a very polite game. Today, tennis...
Ace. raises a racket.
Flying feet.
The style, the play, and the players are intense, athletic, and hard-charging. Flying Feet Sports Shoes welcomes the evolution of tennis and its battling players with a full line of specialty tennis shoes worthy of the new game. These aren't stand-around, look-pretty shoes. These are co-conspirators for the court. Shoes that will endure opponent after opponent, match after match. Shoes that move when and how you move and stop at your command. Shoes that fit and feel good so your feet are ready and able to take that next set. Flying Feet's team includes Asics, New Balance, Wilson, and K-Swiss in widths that fit, and the Flying Feet staff is always on the sidelines ready to help with your selection. Tennis, it's a whole new game. Be prepared to play it well.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, just off exit 18 of I-83, right behind Domino's in York.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles, whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both. It is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
Follow York Sports on your Android. Search Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the fourth here at Santander Stadium. Still a 1-1 tie between the Revolution and the River Sharks. Brandon Boggs settles in for his second at-bat. Bill Murphy's first pitch to Boggs. Inside for ball one. It'll be Boggs, Perez, and Pounds. Middle of the order, due up for the Revolution. 1-0 from Murphy. Inside again for ball two. Two balls, no strikes on Boggs. Two-zero from Murphy, misses again, this time for ball three. A hitter's count now for Brandon Boggs, three balls, no strikes. And this one finds the corner. Boggs thought it was a walk, was about to take off the ankle brace. But not so fast as Jim Clayton behind the plate. Three balls, one strike now for Boggs. 3-1 swung on and missed by Boggs. Full count now. Three-two from Murphy, misses, and that's ball four. Boggs gets his base.
Ball five.
Indeed, Darryl. Not a fan of anything. Ball fives especially. Regardless, no outs. Brandon Boggs at first of a walk, and Andres Perez now up for his second at-bat of the evening. Led off his night of a solo home run that just absolutely took orbit again. We were just talking about that walk-off homer he hit just a little while ago here at Santander Stadium that was just rocketed. Murphy misses outside for ball one. Start off Perez. It's hard to find a hotter hitter than Dre right now. He's just been taking off the later part of the season. 1-0 pitcher Murphy finds the zone for strike one. Dre currently seventh in the league. And batting average at 290 coming into this evening, now at 291 with the homer in the second. 1-1 the count, and Murphy checks over at first at Boggs standing. They were able to throw Mikey Reynolds out in the first. Patty Matera able to get the jump on Reynolds. Don't see that too often for base runner of Reynolds' speed. 1-1 on Dre, and Murphy the throw. Misses inside ball two. Landis Wilson had to go to his left to try to snag that one. Two balls, one strike for Dre. Murphy now readies in the 2-1. Swung on and missed by Perez. Two balls, two strikes now.
Charge!
Thank you, Darryl. 2-2 for Dre. Next offering from Murphy, swung on by Perez and fouled to the first base side. Upper part of the bat. Still got a good piece of that ball and out of play. Still two balls, two strikes for Perez. All-time hit king for the Revolution, currently at 443 hits in his career. 101 doubles as well. Had on 156 extra base hits with that as well. 2-2 misses. This one inside as well. Now a full count for Perez. That walk to Boggs ended a streak in this game for Murphy where he struck out 5 in a row. Ended the second with consecutive strikeouts to Paniagua and Simmons, and then struck out the side in the third with Reynolds, Valdez, and Patterson. Now is struggling a tad here in the fourth. 3-2 swung on and missed by Perez. You know what? I'll just not mention the strikeouts then. Perez down swinging. Had 6 strikeouts for Murphy this evening. All of them strikeouts swinging. One away in the bottom of the fourth. A 1-1 tie here between the Revolution and the River Sharks. Brian Pounds now up for his second at-bat of the evening. Grounded out the third, his first time up in the second. And the first offering from Murphy to Pounds. Gets a piece of it, lifts it, but hangs up in right field for Carlos Guzman, and he'll put it away. That's two away now in the bottom of the fourth. Telvin Nash for his second at-bat of the evening. Started his night with a single in the second. Has made some nice plays tonight. Had a nice diving slide into first to get out a runner. First one from Nash popped up at first base. Guzman can't see it. And it lands in a somewhat embarrassing spot that he should have grabbed it in foul territory. He'll hoist his hand up. Almost a my bad motion. Just sort of lost that one in the lights. It's an 0-1 count now for Nash after that foul.
Matera lost it too.
Well, at least they're in better company. 0-1 now for Nash. Fouls another one off the top of the net this time for 0-2. I'll just do that, Darryl. Messing with his setup there. 0-2 for Nash. Throw from Murphy near the dirt. Ball one. One ball, two strikes for the big guy. Murphy standing, trying to get on the same page with his catcher, Landis Wilson. Finally agrees, and the 1-2 misses outside for ball two. Two balls, two strikes for Nash. Two and two for Nash. You'll look at that one. And Jim Clayton behind the plate will strike him out. Nash is not happy with that. Murphy just got the outside corner, and that will end the inning. It's still a 1-1 tie here at Santander Stadium between the Revolution and the River Sharks as we now head to the top of the fifth.
An invasive pest that's already killed millions of ash trees is bearing down on our communities. The emerald ash borer, or EAB, means certain death for every ash tree it infects. The good news is that you can protect your property's ash trees with help from Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, Our EAB prevention methods are effective, environmentally safe, and less costly than removing your dead tree, which is the only alternative to prevention. Learn more at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
Revolution!
Sure, you're counting down to kickoff, but there's plenty of baseball left this summer. The York Revolution have 14 home games in September, and it's easy for you to be there with the September 6-pack. Six tickets for any remaining game at Santander Stadium this season, two parking passes, and a free $10 food card for ballpark treats. A savings of 25% over box office prices, plus 10 bucks in free food. So head to YorkRevolution.com to purchase your September 6-pack. As Yogi Berra would say, baseball season ain't over till it's over.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Use your gold card every time you shop, and you'll automatically receive your savings and rewards. And you'll get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Nell's, Sauble's, Wetzel's, Chris's New Oxford, and Stouffer's Downingtown Markets. So get into the game with some great savings at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Always a hit and always a great catch.
There's only one place for local high school sports. Sports Radio 1350.
Top of the fifth at Santander Stadium. Still a 1-1 scoreless. Not scoreless, of course. It's a 1-1 tie. A scoreless inning, though, in the Revolution. Bill Murphy finding the rhythm. Two strikeouts in his fourth inning. Scarpetta still on for the Revolution. It'll be Rocket, Matera, and Chavez this inning. Starts off Rocket with an inside pitch that has him rocketing back just a tad. One ball, no strikes early on Michael Rocket. He starts tonight in the infield playing third base. He has done so his entire series. 1-0 swung on from Rocket and drops right in front of James Simmons in center field. Had a good beat on it, but just dropped faster than he expected. It'll be a leadoff single for Michael Rocket in the top of the fifth. Runner at first now on Rocket. No outs, and Paddy Matera due up. He is 1-for-2 this evening of a fly out to center. And then a single in the third. He chose bunt in the first pitch from Scarpetta. Just drops it right in front of him, foul. One ball, no strikes for Matera. He started off the year very well. Since this series in particular, he's just not been able to find any rhythm at the plate. 0-for-8 this series before the single in the third. 0-1 pitch from Scarpetta misses for ball one. One ball, one strike for Matera. Scarpetta readies again, takes another look at Paniagua, then throws the 1-1. Bunt again from Matera, but this time goes foul towards the third base side. Pounds had a nice track on it, though. He is in the zone in his typical fielding position at third base tonight. Fielding is something he's been working on very intently this season. Pounds typically known for his power, but this season has certainly shown his finesse on the field, especially at third base. Has some tremendous grabs just right above the dirt, including a liner towards his way tonight from Matt Yamel. 1-2 pitch from Scarpetta inside. Matera tracks back a bit. Two balls, two strikes now for Paddy Matera. Scarpetta ready again in the 2-2. This one misses low. Three balls, two strikes, a full count now for Matera. Scarpetta looks in, nods yes to Paniagua, steps off the mound briefly. Patty McTerra, his second New Jersey-based team in the Atlantic League. He played for the Newark Bears in 2010 and 2011. Full count. A throw from Scarpetta inside again. This almost near the shoulder of Matera. He scoots back a little bit, trying to avoid getting hit. Then it's a walk to Matera. Now runners at second and first with Rocket at second and Matera walk given first. And still no outs in the inning. Pitching coach Paul Fletcher will come out to talk some mechanics with Scarpetta. He and Scarpetta have worked very closely the past few days since Scarpetta's last start in Somerset to work on some mechanics, work on some things that he saw that Scarpetta can refine on, especially in his off-speed pitches, which, if they can land where he wants them and pinpoint them correctly, can be deadly for any batter.
Now he's definitely had a much better start to this point. He's stayed out of the big inning, knock on wood. Hopefully he can do that here. But he was behind a lot of hitters, I thought, at Somerset. And, you know, maybe a little bit amped up his first start with a new team. But I think command-wise, he's been much better tonight, even though that was his second walk, only his second walk of the night.
Certainly a sign that the refinements he and Fletch have gone over have done the job for the most part. He looks much more comfortable this time out in the Revs uniform. Brandon Chavez settles in, and he shows bunt. First pitch from Scarpetta. Scarpetta comes away from the mound to field it, and the throw is high to first. Reynolds came over to cover. Chavez will go to second on it. It will score Michael Rocket. Now it's going to be 2-1 River Sharks lead here in the fifth. The stalemate has been broken in a rather unfortunate way there.
Yeah, I just said how his command was better than that throw to first base, unfortunately. And that's a tough throw because as he's winding up to make that throw, there's nobody at first yet. That was another one we said earlier tonight, kind of like a quarterback leading your receiver. And he was anticipating Mikey getting there, but with nobody to throw it to directly at the bag when he let it go, it just sailed high, and that's an unfortunate way to end his night. He pitched a solid game, and I think definitely it took a step forward from that start at Somerset on Friday night of last week.
Yeah, certainly a better outing this time around, but he somewhat ends on a sour note. Is he pitched well enough to stay in this game just a tad more, but that errant throw probably shortened his night just a tad. As Mace has made the pull, and it'll be Bo Vaughn coming in for relief for Scarpetta. This is an outing that I think Scarpetta can focus on the positives, and there's something more for him to Fletch to work with and build on, of course, going forward. I think the next start we see from Scarpetta, regardless whether it's here at Santander Stadium or on the road, he'll become even more refined and take another step closer to that very dangerous pitcher we saw in 2014 in Lancaster before he got signed by the Braves organization. He's still that guy and still has that ability, Darryl, for sure.
Yeah, he's got really good stuff, I think. I think he can be a horse. He's a former, you know, second-ranked prospect in the Brewers system. He's just kind of working through some stuff right now, and it's been a turbulent season for him when you factor in and missing about 2 months with that hamstring injury. That's tough on anybody. And, you know, if he makes that throw to first, maybe they leave him in to face Guzman here, but you don't want the big inning. It's going to be second and third with a run already home. And, you know, again, he's not totally built up yet. So that was 75 pitches, and that's where his night will end tonight. But yeah, he pitched pretty well tonight. Unfortunate that the outing would end on that throwing error. It's a sacrifice bunt also for Chavez, his second of the night.
Bo Vaughn now in relief for the Revolution. He will face Carlos Guzman. 1-for-2, an RBI double in the first, and a ground out back to the mound his second time up in the third. First pitch from Bo to Guzman's a little low for ball one. One ball, no strikes for Guzman. Without fail, Daryl. Without fail. 1-0 swung on by Guzman. The dive from Telvin Nash near first. He stops it, and its momentum with it stopped along with the dive from Nash, but cannot make a play on it after that. And it will score Patty Matera. He comes around. It will now be a 3-1 River Sharks lead. Be a base hit for Guzman. RBI single for him. That was second driven in of the night with that RBI single. And I think Nash made the best play possible on it. Give Guzman credit. He hit that in the right location. And the gap between second and first, and Nash made the best diving attempt possible to try to get a snag on it and get on top of it, but just not fast enough.
Yeah, he's made a couple great plays tonight. He almost made another one there, but just off the end of his glove and into an unfortunate spot.
Joel Guzman now up for his third at-bat of the night. Bo starts him off with a strike.
I realize this may not be the time for humor, but I know you're getting tired of me opening the soda can on the mic. Go ahead, Ray.
Yeah, let's just say, yeah. 0-1 from Bo. Peel to first says he did not go. One ball, one strike now for Joel Guzman.
I was going to tell you that the fizz hit me right in the eye.
Oh, good, good, good. Hope it tinged just a bit. 1-1 swung on and missed by Guzman. One ball, two strikes for him.
But I didn't open it all the way.
Oh, goodness gracious. Certainly dynamic and lively, I will say. Not deadly. 1-2 for Guzman. Next throw from Vaughn. Guzman just gets a piece of it, but it still lifts foul out of play towards the third base side. No red fielder able to make a play on it. Takes a heavy bounce up near to the hop corner there.
Yeah.
Not all perfect.
Didn't it used to be hot, as I referred to it as last night?
I think that corner is always the hot corner, especially in Sports Center in the late evenings. Always a lively bunch when they're live from L.A. Still 1-2 on Guzman after that foul. And the next one swung on and missed by Guzman. Way outside pitch that Guzman just chased, and he regrets that. It's a strikeout for Bo Vaughn, and one away now here in the top of the fifth. Matt Gamble now up for his third at-bat of the evening. The runner's advance now is Chavez is at third and Carlos Guzman at second.
He got a good jump on that pitch, and Paniagua just holding on to it on a steal.
Got enough time to certainly get that base. First pitch from Vaughn to Gamble popped up towards the third base side with foul and out of play. But no matter how far it careens towards the stands, especially on the third base side, Brian Pounds already there before it even hits the stands. He is just has a lot of hustle at third base tonight, Daryl. He is just, as the season has gone on, I mentioned earlier that he's just ever so slightly refined the mechanics of his fielding each and every time he's on the field and had a tremendous season thus far. 0-1 from Bo called strike two from Jim Clayton. All Gamble could do was look at that one. 0-2 for Gamble. He's 1-for-2 this evening of a line out the third, his first time up, then a single, his second time up in the fourth. 0-2 from Vaughn, swung on by Gamble. A rocketing shot, but this is foul towards the first base side. Still 0-2 for Gamble, the former Patriot. Native of Jacksonville, Florida. He's drafted by the Brewers in the fourth round of the 05 amateur draft out of Chipola College in Maranatha, Florida. Definitely a Florida boy, born and raised, and sort of out of his human element, though it certainly feels that way with the weather tonight. 0-2 swung on and missed by Gamble. Bo feeling it tonight. That's his second strikeout, both of them consecutive. Now two away here in the top of the fifth. Daniel Rocket now up for his third at-bat. He's 0-for-1 if a walk in the second. flew out his second time up in the fourth, the center field. He's ready, and so is Bo. And whoa, look out. This first offering from Bo to Daniel Rocket, way inside. And Rocket takes a jump back of his right side to get out of the way of that one. One ball, no strikes for Rocket early. Bo not happy of that sloppy throw. He'll take a jog around before he settles back in, but makes quick work of this 1-0 pitch that finds his zone for strike one. One ball, one strike now on Daniel Rocket. One. Next pitch from Bo finds the outside corner for ball two. One ball, two strikes now on Daniel Rocket. Of course, Daniel Rocket on the team with his brother Michael, and I'm sure there's some sibling competition, and this was them trying to see who could hit more home runs. Definitely the advantage of Daniel Rocket, 14. His brother Michael's one. 1-2 pitch from Bo, missed outside for ball two. Two balls, two strikes. I'm sure the Rocket brothers are pretty competitive and probably have all types of contests to see who's better. I'm sure Daniel Rocket holds high over his brother Michael's head that he has more power, but can't find the connection there as the 2-2 from Vaughn swung on and missed by Rocket. Bo, an excellent outing in relief thus far. He strikes out the side to get the Revs out of the top of the fifth. But the Camden Riversharks score two to break the deadlock, and it's now a 3-1 Camden lead as we head to the bottom of the fifth.
Maple Donuts knows that there comes a point in every kid's summer when the feeling of unfettered freedom begins to fold up faster than a picnic blanket at the first drop of an unexpected summer storm. Charlie and his Maple Donuts team understand that all too soon, lazy mornings on the sofa, splashing in the pool, and weeknight sleepovers will be replaced by bus stops, backpacks, and morning announcements. But Maple Donuts says there's a bright side to the first day of school, kids. Because when you stumble into the kitchen that first morning, chances are you'll be greeted by Mom, enjoying her cup of Maple Donuts' famous coffee and sitting next to a back-to-school tradition, a box of Maple Donuts. And somewhere buried in that box, hand-picked by Mom from Maple Donuts' 58 varieties, you may find that, yes, summer is over, but another school year may not be so bad after all. So for every kid coming to grips with going back to school, we say thanks, Mom. And thank you, Maple Donuts.
Maple Donuts taste right.
All right, let's try this one. Wherever you are, W-O-Y-K is... That blows. How about... wherever you are, W-O-Y-K is watching. Oh, no, that's creepy. Let's try this. Take Sports Radio 1350 on the go with the new WOYK mobile apps. Available for download today. Bingo. The new Sports Radio 1350. Available anywhere via the WOYK mobile apps. First in York, first in sports.
Hi, this is Dan Patrick. Join me weekday mornings at 9 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the fifth here at Santander Stadium. It's a 3-1 Riversharks lead over the Revs. They score two in the fifth. Paniagua leads off the Revolution offense this inning, followed by Simmons and Reynolds. Bill Murphy still on the pitch. A fifth for the Riversharks. Starts off Paniagua with a strike. 0-1 outside for ball one. One ball, one strike. Carlos Guzman, one of the ones who did the damage against the Revolution last inning, an RBI single. He's now driven in two. 1-1 pitch from Murphy to Paniagua. Swung on and missed. One ball, two strikes now for Pani. 1-2 from Murphy. Misses outside for ball two. Two balls, two strikes now on Pani. Cody Scarpetta's night would end last inning and a nice outing, but throwing error would be the final action of his night. Unfortunately, Bo Vaughn would come in relief, then strike out the side. The Revolution very much in this. 2-2 swung and a miss by Panny, but it goes past Landis Wilson, and he will reach first base. No matter which way you get about it, getting on base is important. Not the prettiest way to do it after striking out, but avoiding the tag, but regardless, effective. James Simmons now up for his second at-bat.
It's actually how a big rally for Lancaster started last night. One of those strikeouts that they didn't get the out on.
Murphy starts out Simmons. Ball outside. And give Panny credit. He's had quite the series, especially last night. And while that's technically his second strikeout, still contributing any way he can to the Revs offense in this homestand currently. 1-0 to Simmons, swung on and missed. And one ball, one strike.
By the way, Lancaster leads 3-2, bottom of the fourth, hosting Southern Maryland on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard.
Well, that's unfortunate, isn't it?
Sure is, Ray.
Let's hope the Blue Crabs bats start clicking down in Lancaster. 1-1 throw from Murphy. Can't find the corner for ball two. Two balls, one strike now on Simmons. 0-1 of a strikeout, his first time up in the second. 2-1 from Murphy. This one outside as well for ball three. Three balls, one strike for Simmons.
Sure is tough being a Blue Crab fan these days like we are.
Well, situationally, yes.
Or at least yesterday.
Yes. There are times this season when we were not Blue Crabs fans, Daryl.
That's true.
3-1 for Simmons. And pitch from Murphy swung on by Simmons and hit foul towards the first base side. Lifting shot, foul. Full count for Simmons. I'm sure he would like a hit for his birthday, and I'm sure he's put the extra effort in to try to get it, but he'll take a walk as 3-2 from Simmons down near the dirt, near the feet. Murphy to Simmons on that one. It's a walk. Now runners at second and first, and Peniagua and Simmons. No outs still in the bottom of the fifth. Mikey Reynolds now up for his third at-bat.
Well, I hope you like pitching and catching, because out of the last 11 hitters, one batter has put the ball in play. Everybody else has either struck out or walked.
Interesting way to see it. Base runners regardless. Any lack of base hits. Reynolds shows bunt on the first offering from Murphy, but it was foul for strike one.
I mean, there's been one Camden fielder that has touched a ball since the second inning. Hopefully they fall asleep out there and the Revs can take advantage.
They haven't had a base hit since the second themselves, with a solo home run from Andres Perez and a single from Nash. But still have had opportunities to score afterwards. 0-2 on Reynolds after another bunt attempt. Reynolds led off the game with a walk, but was thrown out at second to end the inning, but then struck out his second time up in the third. Murphy readies in the 0-2. Swung on by Reynolds. Fielded by Chavez at short. Gets it to Matera at second. And they cannot complete the turn to first. It'll be a fielder's choice.
Good hustle from Mikey. I mean, he hasn't been hitting the ball the way he'd like recently, the way he's accustomed to, but after getting on top of one, he didn't hang his head and assume it's a double play. He started running hard right away and turned it into a somewhat productive out, depending on what Valdez can do here. Move the lead runner to third with only one out.
Certainly with Reynolds' speed, it was going to be difficult to try to turn that double play. It's runners at the corners now with Peniagua at third and Reynolds at first with one out. Wilson Valdez up. He shows bunt. First pitch from Murphy. Murphy fields it just to the left of the mound. The throw over to Guzman at first is in time, however. Sacrifice is good, though. Valdez now with his second sacrifice bunt of the evening.
And that was supposed to be a squeeze if he could have gotten it past the pitcher, but Murphy came off the mound. He gloved it. Paniagua, not the fastest runner, obviously, from third. You know, if you have a Constanza when he was here, or even Mikey or Simmons, somebody like that, they might make a break for it and try it. But I think Paniagua did the right thing. I think the bunt was supposed to get past Murphy, and when it didn't, he played it safe and got back to third.
Certainly a situation where best case, bases are loaded, but worst case, you at least advance a runner to second in Reynolds. Patterson now up for his third at-bat. Murphy starts him off with a strike that just finds the inside corner. Patterson 0-for-1. He was hit by a pitch in the first and struck out his second time up in the third. 0-1 from Murphy. Patterson just got a piece. Goes towards the backstop. No 1-2 on Patterson. Revs have an opportunity to score with Paniagua at third and Reynolds at second. Patterson just get a hold of one. They have a nice chance. 0-2 misses inside for ball one. One ball, two strikes now for Eric Patterson. In the early parts of the season, Patterson just couldn't get it going with runners in scoring position, but has brought up those numbers significantly here in the second half. 1-2 misses a tad high. Two balls, two strikes now for Eric Patterson. Patterson's one of those players where if the batting isn't going, he still can have his fielding to rely on, and if vice versa as well. One of those players of both abilities. 2-2 swung on by Patterson, and a diving grab from McPhee in left, one of their better outfielders. He puts it away with an excellent diving grab, and that will end the inning, and unfortunately will make it a scoreless fifth for the Revolution. It's still a 3-1 Camden lead as we head to the top of the sixth here at Santander Stadium.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA certified technicians. Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
High school football is back, and so is the High School Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Traditional rivals West York and Central meet Friday night. I'm Ron Ruman. Gareth Hissong and I will have the action on GameTimePA.com. Jeremy Jones, West York's former offensive coordinator, returns after 2 years at the helm of York Suburban to fill the large shoes of his former head man, Ron Miller. Brad Livingston begins his 34th year as Panthers head coach. Central at West York Friday at 6:30 on the High School Game of the Week presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on GameTimePA.com.
On air, online, and on your smartphone. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Top of the sixth, it's a 3-1 Camden lead, and Zach McPhee is saving the potential tying two on that diving play near the line in left. Luis Perdomo will take over for the Revs. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. In a way, it's almost good that they're going to get some bullpen work tonight. There has not been much of it here recently with the off day Monday included.
Revolution certainly having a rested bullpen to use, which is a key advantage for them possibly in this evening's contest.
Going to have to get that key hit, though. They were denied of what would have only been their third hit all night, but would have tied the game. Landis Wilson will lead it off for Camden as we start the sixth inning. Perdomo on a pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. He fires and misses down and away. 8-9-1 in the order for Camden. By the way, earlier tonight, the announcement went out. A big one. Here's the 1-0. And a swing and a tapper foul behind the plate. The Revs will be hosting the Redland Little Leaguers here on the last day of the regular season. And they will be wearing replica Redland Little League jerseys that will be auctioned off that day. How awesome is that? Here's a tap foul behind the plate. Proceeds will benefit Redlands Little League. And to wrap up the regular season, the national champs from right here in York County will pay their home county pro team a visit. Here's a swing and a miss. Perdomo gets Wilson on a slider. And one away to begin the sixth. So they will get a hero's welcome here and be introduced to the crowd that day. And the plan is for them to even take some BP on the field once gates are open for that special 2 p.m. start now. It originally on the schedule was a 5 p.m. Sunday, but that last day of the season, September 20th, moved to 2 p.m. Here's Zach McPhee, who takes low. Glances off Paniagua's glove and rolls back. I saw one guy tonight in the crowd with a Redland Little League t-shirt. So you'll be able to bid on the replica jerseys on Sunday the 20th. Here's a foul back and out of play. McPhee, a fly out and a ground out, but most importantly, saving two runs on that diving catch to end the fifth and Rob Patterson. 1-1, and a swing and a jam shot loop toward the third base dugout. It'll land right in front of it, though, before Pounds can get there. As it bounces up and over the dugout. 1-2, and Pounds still has some buddies on that side. His teammates with last season. Camden a 3-1 lead here in the sixth. Perdomo the pitch. Strike three called. Backdoor slider. Or at least a cutter. It had tail to it. Started off the plate and cut across. And McPhee rung up. Well, Bill Murphy has racked up the K's tonight, but for the Revs as a staff, that's their seventh. Bo struck out the side last inning. Scarpetta had two. Perdomo's got two. Here's Michael Rocket, top of the order. He lines a foul into the seats, first base side. 1-for-3, singled and scored, leading off the fifth. On the 0-1, and a swing and a miss. Good fastball, that one at 92. Now Perdomo ahead. Now he fires, swing and a miss, struck him out on the slider, and he strikes out the side. Bo and Perdomo have combined for six strikeouts in a row. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning tonight. It's still Camden 3, York 1.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
Savory's Funnel Cakes have brought their delicious funnel cakes from the York Fair to Santander Stadium. Be sure to visit their stand on the third base concourse near the hot corner as they offer both regular and pumpkin funnel cakes. Also, be sure to check out Savory's Funnel Cake Eating Challenge played between innings during York Evolution home games. They also offer event catering. Give Savory's a call at 717-271-3485. That's 717-271-3485. Savory's Funnel Cakes, York's delicious delicacy for all to enjoy.
The radio home of the Revs. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the sixth, 3-1 Camden. Bill Murphy done for the night as Michael Click comes on. Also, another announcement from the Revs earlier today, the modified parking for tomorrow and Friday the 18th, as York High will be hosting football games at small athletic fields. So that will not be available tomorrow or Friday the 18th, but alternate parking will be provided at the Northwest Triangle lot, located on Beaver Street with inside of the ballpark. And to get their turn onto North Street off of George, take a left onto Beaver to park in that lot. So that'll be available tomorrow. Fans holding parking passes to any handicapped areas or skybox holders with passes for the Queen Street lot will be unaffected. And other lots usually in use for home games will also be unaffected. And that is a heads up for tomorrow. Revs host the Bluefish. Here's Boggs leading it off against Click. He takes a strike. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Click, a scoreless eighth in the game last night. He's in there a little earlier tonight with his team in front. Murphy with 95 pitches through five innings. All of those strikeouts adding to his pitch total. Boggs will ask for time and back away. Murphy, five innings, just two hits, one run. He walked three, struck out eight. Really, his roughest start of the year was pretty early this season. He's had a lot of quality starts, and Revs ran into him on a good night. The 0-1, that misses away. So now it's Click, who's one of several pretty good arms in their bullpen. He's 5-1, a 2.03 ERA in 52 outings. 1-1, swung on, line to right center field, and pass Carlos Guzman in the gap and all the way to the fence, and Boggs is into second with a double. It was beyond the reach of Guzman, who went over toward the gap. And it flies right through and all the way back to the fence. A leadoff double to begin the bottom of the sixth. That's how Camden's bullpen is greeted. And here's Andres Perez, who back in the second provided the only run against Murphy with that tape measure home run. It's 1-for-2 on the night with that solo shot. His 14th of the year pulls him into a tie for fourth in homers in the league. First pitch is up high. He's gone deep back-to-back nights, and also now the second in Revs history to get to 50 home runs in a York uniform. The 1-0, and that's over for a strike. League-leading 72nd RBI. He's now hit 11 of his home runs since mid-July. Tremendous second half. There's the stretch. 1-1 from Click, and it's a slider down and away. Speaking of home runs, Click is who Dre took deep for that walk-off that will be permanently etched on our retinas back in July. One of the more incredible shots we've seen here. Swings here and launches one high in left center, but he'll stay in the park. Daniel Rocket, the center fielder under it, catch is made. He'll get it in quickly to third as Boggs stays put. And Perez just got under that one a little bit. Mentioned his 50 home runs. Chris Noack's Revs record is 59. So great, nine away from that mark. Here's Brian Pounds, who's grounded out and flied out. Three to one our score here in the bottom of the sixth. Both teams in their bullpens. First pitch to Pounds, a fastball over for a strike. The throwback from Wilson was in the dirt of the mound, but Click able to handle it. I know Click is one of Pounds' pals from Camden last season. One swing and a miss, had a good rip, fastball at 92. Revs trying to do something with the leadoff double from Boggs to begin the inning. All set. The 0-2, swing and a miss. Got him on a high fastball. A Click got him to go upstairs. Two down in the inning. Kept pumping Pounds with high fastballs. And here's Talvin Nash. Nash tonight a single and a strikeout looking. He is 1-for-2 on the evening. First pitch to him, it's up high, he lays off. Murphy kind of bottling up the Revs tonight. Three starts ago, he had a two-hit shutout against Lancaster and struck out 10 in that game. So he got them too. Lancaster right now tied with Southern Maryland 3-3 in the sixth. Blue Crabs have tied it on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard. There's the stretch and the 1-0. That's down low. As Wilson stabs it just above the dirt. The hitters count for Nash. And he'll look to zero in on something. Click ready. And the 2-0, swung on, line down the line, and left and a fair ball. That'll get one home. Boggs around third to score. Nash heading for second. The throw, the slide, he's punched out. As Zach McPhee adds to his night in the outfield. A one-hop throw to second from the corner. And Matera got the tag on Nash right as he was sliding in hard. But he does pick up a single and an RBI, scoring Boggs, who had led off with a double. One run, two hits, nobody left. A one-run game as we move to the seventh tonight. It's the Sharks 3, the Revs 2.
Want to learn to skate? Want to suit up and learn how to play some hockey? Come to the coolest place in town, York Ice Arena. Learn to skate programs are now available for all ages. For every skating ability, kids of all ages will learn how to feel comfortable on ice, how to stand, and perhaps most importantly, how to fall properly. Class levels range from beginner to freestyle, where you'll learn basic jumps, spins, and footwork. Classes are taught by York Ice Arena skating instructors from White Rose Figure Skating Club. No skates? No problem. Skate rental is included in your registration. Or get on the ice for our York Ice Arena hockey programs. York Ice Arena coaches will focus on teaching proper techniques needed for anyone interested in playing hockey. Rental equipment is available for beginning players, both boys and girls. So get on the ice. Learn to skate. Learn to play. Sign up now. Group skating lessons and beginners hockey programs are forming now. Plus, York City residents get a 50% discount. Register today. Go to YorkSkate.com and click on program info. York Ice Arena, the coolest place in town.
Hey, sports fans, great news. Now you can listen to Sports Radio 1350 anywhere with the new WOYK mobile apps. Stranded in Siberia? No problem. Kidnapped by wolves? It's not as bad as you may think. Wherever you are, WOYK is with you on the brand new mobile apps. York's only local sports station just went mobile and global. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports. All about local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Top of the seventh, 3-2. Revs within a run. Mace checking on Nash, out by first between innings, but he'll stay in. A hard slide trying to get to second. And Patty Matera leading off against Perdomo, who spikes the first pitch and it deflects back to the screen. And Nash will stay in the game. He does bring him within one. The 1-0, and that's over for a strike. Matera 1-for-2 tonight. Has a single, also a walk and a run. And Perdomo is staying in to begin this seventh inning. He fires, swung on, grounded foul, third base side. Perdomo, a strikeout of the side in order in the sixth. That came right after Bo had struck out the final three hitters in the fifth. Perdomo the stretch, and the 1-2. Swung on, line to left center, a base hit. Matera reaches out and gets it. And behind in the count, he ends the string of strikeouts with a leadoff single. On 1-2, his second hit of the night. Brandon Chavez up next. Revs have Josh Judy up in the bullpen. They'd been using him before the ninth inning recently, and Mike DeMarc in the ninth. Here's Chavez, who squares to bunt, pulls back, and a pitch missing low. He is going for his third sack bunt of the night. He's 1-for-1, singled and scored in the first, two sack bunts since. He reached on an error on the one in the fifth that helped in their two-run inning. The 1-0 swung on, tap foul over to Carlos Guzman, who's on deck. And that time swinging away, and the bunt was off. Tricky, tricky. What will they do next? Perdomo stretches, and the 1-1. He will not show a bunt. He'll take outside. But if Pounds were to back all the way up at third, they probably would bunt again. So he's got to stay honest. Middle infield set up at double play depth. The 2-1, and it misses high and away. They asked for a new ball. Perdomo has gone two innings in a game twice with York. Judy is up, so it remains to be seen if he does that tonight. 3-1, swung on, ripped through the right side. It's a base hit. Matera up to second. He'll take his time trotting in there. And Chavez with a hit, officially now 2-for-2. Now it's first and second with none out, and Carlos Guzman coming up. Paniagua walking out to the mound with Perdomo to talk over signs. Ray, I may have overdone it on the meatloaf during your innings.
Did you know?
I mean, it was good.
That's what it was? I knew it was meat of some kind, but I really didn't care.
Yeah, loaf.
Okay.
Very good.
It was. Thanks to Wyndham Garden.
It's Carlos Guzman. First pitch is taken down low. Looked like he was taking all the way. Guzman tonight, 2-for-3. A double and an RBI in the first. An infield hit and an RBI in the fifth. Also a stolen base, his 21st of those this year. He's really put up some numbers. Here's the 1-0. Swung on and trickled foul behind the plate. Looking to drive that one. Now the Revs have to get through the Guzmans here in the middle of the order with a couple of men on base to start this inning. Back-to-back singles for Camden. Perdomo the stretch, and the 1-1 down in the dirt. Paniagua blocking it. Well, the stretch, and the 2-1. Swung on, lined, oh, off the glove of Valdez to Mikey, who picks up, steps on second for one, he throws to third for the tag out. A double play, and that is huge. And Matera had stopped between second and third, thinking it was caught. He was in no man's land. Had it been caught, I don't know how far Chavez was off first, but there could have been a chance at a triple play. But they do get the double play on it, and Valdez up the middle. When it first left the bat, I thought it was into center, but there he was, and reaching way to his left, he got glove on it to knock it down and turns it into two. It'll go 6-4-5. And here's Joel Guzman, who swings and lines a foul into the picnic area in right. Might put a dent on the siding of the picnic pavilion, but we'll have all off-season to fix that. No balls and one strike. Here's the stretch from Perdomo. The 0-1, Carlos Guzman running, a swing and a miss. Paniagua's throw goes into center, but Simmons will back it up. And it was a little bit late, and Mikey kind of reaching it right into the runner. He jumped up, trying to reach around Guzman, and never did get a glove on it. The throw wasn't high. If not for the runner arriving, it would have been catchable. But no error. It's a stolen base. That was a huge, huge double play. Huge break for the Revs a moment ago. But still got to get Guzman now with his namesake at second base. 0-2. And a foul tip off the glove of Paniagua. It moved just enough that he couldn't hang on. Perdomo to the stretch. Another 0-2. Slider, that misses low. Joel Guzman, 2 Ks and a ground out tonight. The 1-2 down and away. Paniagua got a piece, backhanding it out of the dirt and keeping it close. Really had to reach for that. A runner at second again here with two outs. A huge break for Perdomo. He's trying to turn it into a scoreless inning and keep this a one-run game. 3-2 Camden here in the seventh. Revs made it a one-run game just an inning ago. The 2-2 swung on, line right to short. Valdez is there again. This one right at him. And Perdomo with a scoreless top of the seventh. No runs, two hits, and one runner left. A little gamesmanship between Perdomo and Guzman as he walks off, getting the line out to end the inning. We go to the bottom of the seventh. Still a 3-2 Camden lead.
Nobody can turn your backyard into a backyard paradise better than Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping. The outdoor pros at Paradise offer full outdoor maintenance, landscaping, hardscape design, and installation. And when it comes to fall planting, mulching, and cleaning up fallen leaves, you're in luck, Revs fans. Call before September 1st to schedule your fall cleanup and clean up with 10% off. Estimates are free. Fully insured. Call 577-6234 or check them out on Facebook. Paradise Landscaping and Hardscaping in your
Wellspan has helped many professional, student, and recreational athletes stay at the top of their game. And they can do the same for you. Our winning team offers everything from concussion management and sports nutrition to physical therapy and more. For more information, call 877-482-5420 or visit wellspan.org/sportsmedicine.
Get into the ball game with great savings and great weekly specials at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Use your gold card every time you shop and you'll automatically receive your savings and rewards. And you'll get incredible deals on the new Best Yet brand products at Nell's, Sauble's, Wetzel's, Chris's New Oxford, and Stouffer's Downingtown Markets. So get into the game with some great savings at all your favorite neighborhood family markets. Always a hit and always a great catch.
Your teams all the time. York's only place for local sports. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Revs looking for another little late inning magic tonight, trailing 3-2. As we go to the bottom of the seventh, right-hander Dan Blewett is the new pitcher. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. He's had a very good year as well. Saw him work a scoreless eighth in the opener here the other night. Overall for the season, he's gone just 1-5, but he's got the lowest ERA on the team at 2. 45 appearances, 45 innings, 55 Ks, only 11 walks. Just under a hit per inning. Now Paniagua will lead it off. He's 0-2, pair of Ks, but both of those were against Bill Murphy. First pitch from Blewett is high and tight. Fastball at 91. Three runs, eight hits, no errors for Camden. Two runs, four hits, two errors on York. There's the 1-0, swing and a miss on a ball up. Probably out of the strike zone. Those look good though when you've got a bat in your hand. 1-1. And a swing and a liner center field. Right there, though, is Daniel Rocket. He doesn't even have to take one step. And he stood there, angled his feet, waiting for it, and it came right to him. Hit hard, but out number one. James Simmons up next. Simmons a strikeout and a walk here on his 30th birthday. Lewitt, who works from the stretch, comes home. And he misses low. Lancaster and Southern Maryland have gone to the seventh. 3-3 on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard. Summers set up early, 4-0 at Sugarland in the third. Bridgeport and Long Island, 2-2 in the eighth. 1-0. High and tight. Simmons, a late spin out of the way. And it's 2-0. Blewett fires, swung on, bounce foul. Down to Polo at third. Revs have gone 12-3 at home in one-run games, trailing by one run tonight. The 2-1, that's up high. And Simmons will work it into his favor. Top of the order, and Mikey Reynolds waiting on deck. And 3-1, swung on, he pops it up foul and out of play. And will work with a full count. If he can get on, he does bring speed to the table here in a one-run game. Each of the Revs' next several hitters will do that, in fact. Blewett ready, the 3-2, down and away, and Simmons does walk, his second walk taken tonight. So the tying run on, a one-out base runner. We go to the top of the order, and Mikey, who is overdue tonight, 0-2 with a walk. Valdez, normal fans that he waves to behind the plate are up in the Dietz and Blewett Insurance Diamond deck tonight, so as he comes out on deck, he had to look for them. First pitch to Mikey is taken low. Valdez indeed due to follow. Reynolds trying to snap an 0-18 his last five games. Before that, as we said, he had hit safely in six straight. And a throw to first, Simmons back standing. He had also had an RBI in five straight and a run scored in four straight before this cold spell that he's come down with. There's the stretch from Blewett. And the 1-0, fastball, it's over for a strike. Takes a look down at Polo. The Texas A&M product, Mikey Reynolds. The stretch from Blewett. And the 1-1. Breaking ball, hard to the outside, backhanded out of the dirt. He told us on an interview early this season that he would cross paths with Johnny Manziel on campus, and he was just another guy, pleasant to be around. He's battling for a starting job. Simmons runs, Reynolds fouls. On a high fastball back over the roof, they had Simmons in motion. And he'll have to head back 2-2. Does Manziel win the job, Ray?
I think he already lost it to McCown.
Oh, did they decide it already?
Pretty sure.
Yeah. Blewett ready, the 2-2, and look out, this one fouled to the right of the net, and then coming back quickly. And Mikey actually lost the grip on the bat. He'll walk over and retrieve it. Ended up slightly behind him. Revs down 3-2 here in the bottom of the seventh. Blew it again to the plate. Simmons running and a ground ball base hit to right. Simmons slowed down. Oh no, he slipped and now it's fumbled in right, but he'll get back to second and just stop there. And I think he's glad to just be on a base safely, but he should have been at third. He was running on the pitch. Mikey ripped it into right through that gaping opening. And Simmons, I don't know if somebody fooled him in the middle infield. He didn't know for sure that it had gotten through, and he slowed down. I wonder if one of those guys tricked him. And then, as he tried to get it back in gear and hustle to third, he completely lost his footing, slipped and went down. And then Carlos Guzman overran it in right, so he still could have made third, but he was already heading back to second. Two on with one out. Here's Wilson Valdez. 0-for-1 with two sack bunts. First pitch is line center field. Daniel Rocket, though, right there again. And the catch is made. Had Simmons been able to get to third, it would have been a game-tying sack fly. But it's out number two in the inning. It'll be up to Eric Patterson to keep this threat alive. Both outs this inning have been hard hit, but right at Rocket. Glad to see Mikey get a hit, though. That monkey off his back. Patterson tonight, 0-for-2, a hit by pitch. First offering is over for a strike. He was robbed in the fifth. Revs were down two at the time, and Zach McPhee in left made a diving catch to save two runs that would have tied it. Take a hit away from Patterson on that play also. There's the stretch and the 0-1. That's way inside. Simmons at second, the tying run. Mikey on at first, the go-ahead run, both with good speed. Unfortunately for Simmons, he would have been at third and already home if not for that slip. Don't count on that happening, but it did. The 1-1, that's way high. And maybe if not for the hesitation at second, maybe the slip would have never happened. I don't know if one of the middle infielders faked him out. The 2-1. Swung on, popped up. At second base, Matera, or is it going to be first? It's Matera. He's got it. Inning over. If there was a fake on Simmons, it might have been Matera who did it. And he catches the pop-up for the final out. No runs, one hit. Revs leave two in the seventh. They were that close to having a chance to tie it. Still down 3-2 as we head to the eighth.
Providing quality services efficiently and in a timely manner to its clients is the mission of the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins. GSLSC is equipped to handle any real estate transactions, leases, residential and commercial real estate settlements, zoning issues, and all matters involving municipalities. They are also experienced in the formation and operation of family real estate ventures that are tax-sensitive to the needs of the investors. Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins is an approved title insurance agency and can provide you with title insurance and legal representation at one low cost when buying a home or investment property. Don't risk any real estate settlement without an experienced real estate attorney from the law firm of Griffith, Strickler, Lerman, Solomus & Calkins at your side. Phone 717-757-7602. They've been handling residential and commercial real estate matters in South Central Pennsylvania for more than 50 years. With mortgage interest rates at an all-time low, now is the time to buy or refinance. Phone 717-757-7602 today or visit their website, gslsc.com.
This is the Dan Patrick Show. Living on the
He's a great, great man. Was Muhammad Ali a thug? He was colorful, controversial. But this is a guy who did something before anybody else did it. And we were okay with it. A lot of us were okay because of how Ali looked. Handsome, well-spoken, the poetry. There was charisma to it. Richard Sherman just came out of a game and started yelling right in our face.
Dan Patrick on Sports Radio 1350 WOIK. The Revolution plays here. Sports Radio 1350 WOIK.
Top of the eighth, Camden still leads it. They probably should not, but they do. 3-2, Josh Judy takes over. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. That'll be Matt Gamble leading things off. And Judy's first pitch of the inning, lined into left center, a base hit. Gamble slices it toward the gap. Simmons slips on a backhand glove. He'll fire to second, but late. And Gamble in on a slide, a first pitch leadoff double. And again, Simmons lost his footing, this time on the outfield grass. I don't know what's going on with the cleats tonight, but trying to backhand and come to a stop. It's not an easy play, but I haven't seen him slip like that. And it's happened twice in the last inning. Paniagua out to talk with Judy briefly. Daniel Rocket, the hitter, he is 0-2, hit by a pitch also early tonight. Revs down a run. Camden now, after a leadoff double, threatening to add insurance. Judy out of the stretch, couple of checks at second, he'll fire home, and it's a slider, breaks over for a strike. Judy 2-2, a 3.12 ERA, 46 games, 10 saves. Now the 0-1. Fastball misses high. So he will buckle down here and try to work around this leadoff double. Could be a long path back in this inning. He'll be careful. The 1-1. Fastball missed high. Now Southern Maryland's taking a lead in Lancaster, 4-3 in the eighth on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard. The 2-1 slider, and that one bends in for a strike. Good one from Judy to even things up. Logan Williamson's got the pitch chart tonight. He will start the opener against Bridgeport tomorrow night. Battle of the Bands night here. Now the 2-2. Up high, a fastball missing. I don't know if Judy knows yet, because I don't know if Paul has asked him yet. But we're at least going to ask and hopefully get Judy on Revs Friday Night Live tomorrow if he's available. It's Battle of the Bands night, and his face is on our game program with some paint added to it, as if he were from Kiss. Well, the payoff pitch swung on and popped foul back. The Rocket hangs in. Bridgeport and Long Island, they're tied at 2 in the bottom of the ninth at Bethpage Ballpark. Judy the stretch, another full count pitch, and a high pop-up, way up. Valdez out from short, Patterson in from left, Pat calls him off, makes the grab. And there's one away, and Gamble will stay at second on that pop-up. We'll pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Revolution Radio.
First in York, first in sports. Your only local sports station. The new Sports Radio 1350, WOYK, York, Pennsylvania.
Runner at second with one out, Landis Wilson the hitter. He has struck out twice, walked once. And Judy from the stretch stares at Gamble, fires home, and a ground ball slap just foul. Down past the bag at first. It was fairly close with Nash a couple of steps off the line. Almost trouble. We mentioned that Long Island Bridgeport score tied in the bottom of the ninth. They are both tied for second in the Liberty Division second half, one game behind Somerset. He's 28-24. Patriots have a 4-0 lead at Sugarland in the top of the fourth. And Judy the stretch. Couple checks, a third, a fourth. And the 0-1 to Wilson, a slider breaks across, strike called. Wilson didn't play the last couple of years. He last played in the Can-Am League in 2012. So some Frontier League time before that. Here's the stretch, and the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Judy got him on a high fastball. So after the leadoff double, a pop fly and a K. Two down in the inning. Coming up after our game tonight, our first college football broadcast of the season. Number 2, TCU at Minnesota. We'll join it in progress. And tomorrow night, in progress, Washington at Boise State on the blue turf. I'm sure the blue is really, really awesome on radio. As Judy steps off. It's more of a field made for TV, but it'll be a good broadcast nonetheless. Here's McPhee. And Judy the pitch. Oh, inside and off Paniagua's glove. Should have been caught. It'll be a pass ball as Gamble moves to third base. Looked like he stopped himself just short and it hit off the end of his mitt. And it grazed the pant leg of the plate ump, Jim Clayton also. Fortunately, Paniagua was able to redirect it slightly, and Jim didn't have to wear that. A runner at third with two outs, a 1-0 count on McPhee, who's flied out, ground out, and struck out. Pitch, backdoor slider, missed away. Also, tomorrow night, our first high school football broadcast will be online. WOYK1350.com at 6:30, Central at West York. 2-0. Line drive. Oh, just out of the reach of Mikey on a dive. Into right center. And Gamble into score. It's 4-2 here in the eighth. Camden the insurance run. And that ball was hit so hard that McPhee pulled it, but it still sliced. And Mikey laid out to his right, but it was just out of his reach. So close to making a great play on that. But McPhee with another RBI single in this series. Here's Michael Rocket, a slider in, starts him off. Four to two Camden here in the eighth. Now Judy a nod yes. As McPhee on at first, the 1-0 to Rocket, swing and a miss on a slider. Our high school football coverage is brought to you by Wellspan Sports Medicine. So, again, that starts tomorrow. And you can find all of the team previews that Ray did our high school football spotlight presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine on WOYK1350.com. McPhee running. Here's a slider for a strike, and Paniagua's throw got him! He short hopped it to Mikey, who made a brilliant scoop. And just over toward the shortstop side of second, he then had to reach back, and McPhee thought he had gotten in as a result, but called out. Well, one run scores, two hits, nobody left. We'll go to the bottom of the eighth inning. It's the Sharks 4, the Revs 2.
Payne doesn't take Sunday off, neither do we. We're open weekdays 8 to 8 and weekends 9 to 6. Just walk into Wellspan Urgent Orthopedics, 2319 South George Street in York, across from the Apple Hill Health Campus. Visit wellspan.org/urgent orthopedics today.
It's going to be another epic year in high school football, and Sports Radio 1350 is ready for kickoff. Tune in every Friday night this fall for the High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Plus, go to WOIK1350.com for a full breakdown of the teams and the players of the 2015 York Adams League. The High School Football Game of the Week, presented by Wellspan Sports Medicine. Catch the action every Friday night on Sports Radio 1350, online at WOIK1350.com, or download the WOIK mobile app.
We're everywhere. Listen on the go with the WOYK mobile apps. Download today at WOYK1350.com.
Summer is about taking time for what really matters. Spending time with the family, enjoying nature's beauty, having a healthy lawn you can be proud of, plus the time to enjoy it. With Heritage Lawn and Landscape Care, you get world-class environmentally responsible lawn care from a hometown team. The result is a vibrant, beautiful lawn that turns heads and boosts curb appeal. Visit us at heritagelawnandlandscape.com.
Your home for Revolution Baseball, Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Bottom of the eighth, Revs trail 4-2, Camden insurance run. And they will call on reliever Rob Bryson, who takes over here. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Revs, the middle third of the order coming up. Looking for some late inning magic again. Not doubled up in the run column and the hit column tonight. 4-2, Camden up 10-5 in hits. Been a bit of a frustrating night for the Revs, especially at the plate. Bryson in his 48th game, one win, no losses, a 2.23 ERA. Yeah, he's got very good numbers, 48 and a third innings, just 38 hits. Opponents hitting 208, just 16 walks, 52 strikeouts. Brandon Boggs to get things started. Boggs 1-for-2, a double, a walk, a run. Led off the sixth with a double and scored. First pitch is in tight. And when he scored, he made it a one-run game, but Revs weren't able to cash in last inning with an opportunity, and Camden adds insurance in the top half of this inning. But 1-0. Backing away, taking all the way. It's in for a strike. The Boggs, Perez, and Pounds. The 1-1. Swung on, line to right center. Rocket will not lay out. He'll play it on a hop. And Boggs, a leadoff single to begin the home eight. Hard hit again, and toward that gap again, Daniel Rocket keeps it in front, but could only get there in time to play it on the in-between hop, and it's a single for Boggs to lead off. And Andres Perez now will be the tying run. He's 1-for-3, blasted a home run in the second inning. 14th of the year leading the team, 50th all-time with York. First pitch here, swung on and missed. Leads the league with 72 driven in. Now Bryson leaning in and looking. And time finally asked for by Dre. He's now hit five of his 14 homers this year off Camden. The 0-1 swung on, fouled into the netting. And the Revs have only played the Sharks 17 times. It's got five home runs against them. 22 driven in 17 games against Camden. It's not too shabby. Bryson is ahead of him. Here's the stretch. And the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Had him reaching on a slider. And set him up for that. One down. Now Brian pounds to the plate. Four to two Camden here in the bottom of the eighth. Trying to take two out of three in York. The Revs trying to catch Lancaster and need to win series, not lose them, especially against a Camden team that's having a much better second half, but still in the basement as Bryson throws over, Boggs up back on a dive. Long Island has won their game 3-2 with a run in the bottom of the ninth. A waddle-off win at the Duck Pond. First pitch to Pounds is swung on and missed, a fastball. It's on our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard. Like we said, Long Island and Bridgeport both one game behind Somerset for first in the Liberty Division entering play tonight. The 0-1, swing and a foul up against the net. Bryson pumping Pounds in with a fastball too. They've attacked him out of their bullpen. Fastball's up, and that one in. Bryson was not a teammate of Pounds last year. He did not play last season. He was coming back from injury. The 0-2, Boggs running, and it's down and away, blocked by Wilson. Boggs will steal. He thought he could get it. He could. That'll take away any double play chance. Sixth steal of the year for him. And a base hit could make it a one-run score again. Before this year, and Bryson's had a really good year. 2 years ago, he was at AA and AAA in the Indian system. 27-year-old, he is somewhat local from Newark, Delaware. A 1-2, swing and a foul tip. Did he hold on? He did. Actually, that wasn't tipped. That was squeezed. It's a strikeout swinging. I thought he had tipped it. Bryson gets him on the hook. And two down in the bottom of the eighth. Bring up Talvin Nash. The Revs exploded offensively last night, but they were held to two runs on four hits here on Tuesday. Two runs on just six hits so far tonight. Here's Nash. First pitch is looped at second, but in the infield, Matera will come in and catch it. On the fly, on a little floater in front of second, and Nash got jammed. He's out on one pitch to end the inning. The leadoff single from Boggs. He goes left on base. And we go to the ninth tonight. River Sharks still lead it 4-2. We
when she looks up and says, "Dad, I'm playing field hockey." Try not to show fear. She's quite capable of joining that fury of females churning downfield, sticks in hand, ready to conquer and crush the opposition. In fact, in her mind, she's been ready to play. But you won't be ready until you take her to Flying Feet Sports Shoes.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet is the one place that makes sense of all the sports your kids are into, especially field hockey footwear. No, it's not just sneakers, Dad. She'll need shin guards and socks, and don't forget hockey balls, stick bags, grip tape, and hockey sticks from Dita and Gray's Cranberry. Flying Feet covers every player, every size, every ability, even goalie sticks. Dad, you're about to get an education on the art of fierce female competitive instinct, but Flying Feet can help you navigate that treacherous turf. They've been outfitting field hockey players and entire teams since your wife played back in 83.
Flying Feet.
Flying Feet Sports Shoes, 1511 Mount Rose Avenue, York, just off exit 11 of I-83.
Waking up with the Zabe.
The Steve Zabin Show.
When Mike Weir finally won the Masters as a lefty, it had broken like some 70-year stretch or something like that with no lefties winning. But since Mike Weir took the lid off lefties, 6 of the last 12 Masters tournaments have been won by southpaws. Behold your stat of the day.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Your county, your teams. Sports Radio 1350 WOYK. First in York, first in sports.
Top of the ninth, Mike DeMarc takes over. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Michael Rocket leads off, and DeMarc fires a strike to begin the inning. 4-2, Camden the lead. This will be DeMarc's first appearance since Friday night at Somerset, almost a week ago. He closed out a win. 0-1, and a fastball just missed, down and away. All along, we thought that DeMarc had given up just one earned run all season. There's the stretch, the pitch, and a foul tip. Nasty one. Glanced off Paniagua's mask and back to the net. Well, realized today he's charged with 2 earned runs for the year. There was an error and an unearned in the ninth inning of the game Friday at Somerset. At the time, and sometime since then, without informing us, they made it a hit and an earned run. Here's a swing and a liner, golf to left. Patterson will have to play it off the wall. Plays the carom barehanded, fires to second, holds him to a single, and Rocket's got speed. Only gets one bag on it and has to hustle and dive back to first. And he does greet DeMarc with a liner off the sprint sign, just right of the manual scoreboard and left. Still, DeMarc with great numbers this season. No record in 18 games, the ERA at 1.04. It had been under 1, but here's Patty Matera, who's 2-for-3 with a walk and a run. First pitch is swung on, jammed, a pop up to shallow left. Patterson in, he'll get there, and he'll fire it to first. Why not? Rocket had a big halfway lead and has to hustle back. Patterson one hopping it into first. Camden with closer Matt Gorgon getting ready in their bullpen. Here's Brandon Chavez, who's 2-for-2 with a pair of singles, sandwiched around a pair of sacrifice bunts. DeMarc, a high set, and right in the middle of bringing the hands down, he'll whip around and fire to first. Rocket back diving. Rocket's got 4 steals. Digs in on his lead. First pitch to Chavez is outside. DeMarc didn't allow an earned run in 15 and two-thirds innings to begin the year. Not until last week in Lancaster. He fires, missed a little high, 2-0. Pretty impressive. Now ball loose from Camden's bullpen rolling in toward home plate. Revs in the bottom of the ninth will have Paniagua, Simmons, and Reynolds due up. DeMarc stretching high, sets, delivers, and that one's over for a strike. 2-1. Camden will be in Lancaster this weekend, but now they often make day trips for that series. The 2-1, and a ground ball right side. Mikey to his left, handles a tough hop, only plays to first, and he'll dump it off there. He takes the glove off his hand, so I hope he didn't hurt his left hand. Earlier this season, it was the throwing hand that got hurt. Rocket takes second with two down. Puts that glove back on. Was scooting over to his left, got in front of it, handled what could have been a tricky hop on that chopper. Now a runner at second with two outs. Carlos Guzman will stand in. An insurance run out there for Camden. They scored one last inning. First pitch to Guzman. It's across the outside corner, a strike. Left-hand hitter tonight, 2-for-4. RBI double, RBI infield hit. Also two steals. He has been a tough out for the Revs all year. As he steps out, DeMarc will lift the cap and wipe the forehead for a moment. And now ready, here's the 0-1. That's down low. Paniagua to a knee to play it. Camden on top, 4-2 here in the ninth. The stretch, the 1-1. Breaking ball, jammed him, punched toward the middle. Mikey will get to it, and an off-balance throw. Got him at first to end the inning with Rocket sprinting in from third. The throw to first is in time. I thought he might backhand that ball, but he had time to get in front of it. Valdez was right in front of him on the other side of second, but he couldn't quite get to the ball. Mikey could, and an off-balance throw got him at first. Saves a run, no runs, one hit, one left. We'll go to the bottom of the ninth. Last chance for the Revs, trailing 4-2.
Hi, this is Tom Dasher, president of Tom Dasher Investment Services. I specialize in retirement planning and strategies to meet individual personal goals. Whether you are looking for wealth accumulation or to maximize your retirement income. Oh, heck, this is sounding just like another commercial. Hey, listen, it's this simple. We use risk-free investment vehicles. Whether you are looking to still build wealth accumulation or you want retirement income or a combination of both, it is all about getting your money parked in the place that will benefit you the most. If you want to do that, call me. My office number is 246-3879, or my mobile is 487-2096, or contact me at my new website at tomdasher.com.
Broadway Transmission? I don't know how they do it.
We've been in business for 60 years at the same location.
I don't know how they do it.
It's our long-term nationwide warranties.
Oh, and don't forget our online appointment scheduling.
I still don't know how they do it.
They towed in my van at no cost with my repair.
It's our ATRA certified technicians. Don't forget the good-looking genius in the office.
Come on, man.
I know they helped me with financing. Still with my bad credit, I don't know how they do it.
I did my research and felt comfortable that Broadway is a AAA-approved specialty repair shop. I showed my AAA card and saved some hard-earned cash.
I was happy to get a $100 rebate in the mail after the job was done.
I sure don't know how they do it, but I do know they get it done, and they get it done right.
Broadway Transmission. We'll get your shift together and back on the road fast. Check us out on the web at BroadwayTrans.com or stop in and see how it's done.
Join me, Steve Zabin, mornings at 6 on Sports Radio 1350 WOYK.
Of the ninth, Matt Gorgon takes over, and Paniagua leading off. He takes a strike to begin things, trailing 4-2. Pitching change brought to you by Maple Donuts. Camden with a new catcher as well. Mike Kearns, who started last night, is in. Well, the next one to Paniagua, a strike that he didn't like. He thought it was down and away and looked back immediately. He's 0-for-3 tonight. Hit it hard last time, but lined out in center. Gorgon lifts the leg, fires home, and misses upstairs. 1-2. Simmons and Reynolds do as well. Revs held to 6 hits so far tonight. Held to 4 on Tuesday night when Gorgon picked up his 29th save. Now he deals, and that's outside, 2-2. Gorgon 2-1, a 2.11 ERA. The 29 saves are one off the league lead. Pitch missed outside, a full count. John Hunton leads the league with 30, but currently on the DL for Somerset. Now Gorgon ready. And deals. And a swing and a line drive caught at third. Paniagua with a bullet. And Michael Rocket reaching up spears it. Looked like it was ticketed for the left field line. It goes for the first out. And another hard hit out off a Revs bat. And Paniagua's for the second time tonight. That would have brought the tying run to the plate. But it's out number one. That ball was smashed. Here's James Simmons. He's 0-for-1 with 2 walks. First pitch is up. He tries to check. They appeal and he did hold. Tough start to the ninth. Paniagua had a ball that he thought was out of the zone earlier in the at-bat, too. Maybe would have walked. Pitch up high on Simmons, 2-0. Opponents hitting only 167 off Gorgon this season. He's now at 43 innings, just 25 hits. He winds, deals, and that's up. In for a called strike. Two and one, not 3-0. Here's the 2-1, and a liner down the line and left. This one won't be caught. It'll two-hop the wall. Simmons will turn, heads for second as it rebounds away from McPhee, and he's in with a stand-up double. The birthday boy, it'll bring the tying run to the plate. And now that the Revs have the tying run batting, it won't be Mikey Reynolds. It'll be one of their guys with serious power off the bench. Jacob Calderon will pinch hit. A chance to tie it on one swing. Mikey has been in a rut here the last few games. He did single his last time up, which should have helped lead to a run, but did not. He'll be called back for Calderon. Certainly has the power to tie it. And Gorgon's first pitch, it's down low. Revs haven't had a pinch hit home run since 2010. Gorgon into his stretch. And the 1-0. That's over for a called strike. Calderon hitting 296. Got seven home runs. Has a pinch hitter 0 for 2, but does have an RBI. Take a moment and back out. He's also fared very well against righties. 324. The 1-1 swung on, driven in left center. Daniel Rocket hustling over. It'll hang up for him. Makes the catch in left center. Calderon sent it the other way toward the gap, but it hung up for Rocket, and the Revs down to their final out. Two down in the bottom of the nine. And Wilson Valdez to the plate. He's 0 for 2 tonight. Pair of sack bunts. On our York Mitsubishi out-of-town scoreboard, Southern Maryland's up 6-3 in the ninth in Lancaster. Sure would be nice to be able to take advantage of that and get a win here. Revs down to their last out. Here's Valdez. First pitch is a curveball. It bites away. If he can get on, Patterson's on deck. Valdez just trying to get on and extend things. On the 1-0. And a line drive to left, and that'll get in for a hit. It will extend things. Back to the wall. Simmons around to score. Valdez hustles for second, slides in. 4-3, and the tying run is at second base with two outs here in the nine. He ripped it to left. It deflected off McPhee's glove on one hop and against the wall. But it'll be a clean double for Valdez. And Eric Patterson coming up with the tying run at second. Two doubles in the inning. Man, if Paniagua's ball would have been hit just a little higher to start the inning. Patterson stands in. He's 0 for 3 with a hit by pitch. Was robbed of a pair of ribbies earlier tonight. First pitch, swing and a foul back. Revs trying to rally down to their final out, 4-3. Gorgon has not given up much this season. A stretch, a look back, and the 0-1 swung on, popped him up. At shortstop, Chavez is under it. Patterson slams his bat. Chavez the catch. Game over. Catches it right in front of second, and Camden wins 2 of 3 here in York in the series. A 4-3 final tonight. Patterson slammed his bat so hard it may have stuck in the grass. And the Revs rally for a run in the bottom of the ninth, but leave the tying run at second base. They drop 2 of 3 at home to the River Sharks. Not the way they wanted to start off this homestand. A 4-3 final tonight. Gorgon with his 30th save of the year pulls into a tie for the league lead. And the Revs at best will still be 4.5 out when play begins tomorrow, looking to rebound against the Bluefish this weekend. 4-3 the final tonight, a frustrating night for the Revs, who fall by one run in the final meeting against the River Sharks this season.